The following live telecast is an exclusive presentation of Cox Communications in association with KTUL, Oklahoma's News Channel 8.
Well, after the timeout, they have decided to put their fate in the hands of their offensive line. Joel Shackelford, the holder, and junior Aaron Sanders will try his fourth field goal attempt of the year. He's 3 of 3, but inside 30 yards. This one will be from 42 yards to tie the game with 3:12 left. It's got the distance. It is good. Aaron Sanders with a 42-yarder. We'll take another timeout and come back as you see Aaron Sanders tie the game.
Look at that, the hot air balloons are flying. We've got small aircraft. We've got everything here in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. 10,005 people will be seated, and we'll also have standing room only for this one. It is quite an event. Broken Arrow's Memorial Tiger Stadium is now unveiled for the first time tonight. You can hear all the buzz, all the excitement, people running all over the place as we've got the 8th-ranked team in the state, Broken Arrow, hosting the Union Redskins, ranked number 2 in the state and also nationally ranked. You saw some footage from last year as Don King and J.B. Haney called it for you. What a game that was. The 42-yard field goal with about 3 minutes to go sent that game into eventual overtime. What a contest it was. And Don and J.B., can we expect the same kind of thing tonight?
Well, Jack, I think we can certainly expect the same kind of atmosphere as J.B. Haney joins me, the former president of the Oklahoma Coaches Association Hall of Fame member. What is it about the old adage that you don't like to open up as an opponent at a new stadium or a coach that's coaching his last game?
Well, that's something that most coaches really kind of adhere to, because if you go against a new stadium, you know there's going to be great emotion, just tremendous emotion. And then on the other hand, if you know a coach is retiring or maybe is leaving for some reason and it's his last game, you get that same emotion. So it'll be interesting tonight.
Yeah, it will be an interesting atmosphere as we pitch it back to you, Jack.
What a game we expect here tonight, live statewide on Cox Cable. Of course, we're used to bringing you all these games here in Tulsa. Also, great to have you this year in Oklahoma City. Live games on Thursday night from the Tulsa metropolitan area, and then on Friday night, live from Oklahoma City. Here's what happened last week in games that we brought to you. Owosso taking on Booker T. Washington. Look at Lamont Moore. He's already been offered a track scholarship at the University of Oklahoma, not because of just his speed, but also because last year in the state championships, he had the fourth best jump in all of the country, would have placed in the Big 12 tournament. Look at that, though. Booker T. Washington has got a great, great young team. Their quarterback outstanding, not only throwing the ball, but running the draw play there. Washington gave Owosso all they wanted for 3.5 quarters. Caleb Westerfield, the touchdown, though, from Jason Byers, and the Owosso Rams ended up winning by 16 points. Ironically, J.B. Haney told me before the game, a week ago, Owosso would win by 16 points. Don't bet with him. They won 42-26. In the city, Norman and Norman North. What a great contest this was. Just back and forth, kind of busting from the 30 to the 30 all night long. Both teams struggling a bit with the offense, you could say. Great play action fake right there, getting down close to the goal line. Looked like North was really going to take this one to town. Quarterback sneak for the touchdown. They had what looked like a virtual lock on the game and looked like they had things under control. Great defense, deflected pass. It was tough for the Tigers to really get anything going. This looked like it would be the straw that broke the camel's back. The long pass right down into the middle of the field. Man-to-man defense can't contain him, in for the touchdown. Tigers come back though strong. Couldn't quite do it. Look at that. As you saw the final score there for just a moment. Jason White getting into the end zone. Great action on both Thursday and Friday night. 33-24 as the Norman Tigers come back and win. This is Clovis, California. taking on the Union Redskins a week ago. Union Redskins with some incredible defense. Clovis, shocked. They did not think that they could be beaten at all. Came all the way, 1,500 miles across the United States, and it was all Union High School, especially their defense, putting the big goose egg up on the board. Tyler Gooch going across the buddy, hits Jerome Janae. Union Redskins win and win big. The final score, 36-0. Union, unbelievable. In fact, when Clovis called us at Channel 8, asked us the score, we said 36-0. They said, we won 36-0. No, you lost 36-0. They couldn't believe it. They think they're a national power, but they can't compete with Oklahoma brand of football. We're going to come back for more live action on Cox Cable. Broken Arrow's new Memorial Tiger Stadium, 24 minutes, 25 seconds till kickoff. Welcome back to Broken Arrow's brand new Tiger Memorial Stadium. I'm Jack Buns. Don King and J.B. Haney will be with us shortly. Right now we have a little bit better looking, I should say, a lot better looking pair here. We've got Anna Beam and also Melissa Lomas. They are co-captains of the Broken Arrow Tigers cheerleading squad. And first of all, people know how hard the football team works, but you guys have worked all summer as well getting ready for the season too.
Yes, we practice at least 3 days a week at a gym at Callaway Cheernastics for about 3 hours, and we also practice at our high school gym the other days. Right now we're practicing for regionals, and we are practicing a good 3 hours every day.
It's amazing how much work goes into this. What do you enjoy best about cheerleading?
I probably enjoy best being with my teammates and having a good time and, you know, meeting goals that we set with each other. That's what's more important to me.
You all have been so successful. The football team has been very successful. The band has won national championships before. The cheerleaders have also done extremely well over the years.
Last year we were the state champions, and we're hoping to gain that title again the end of September. And in December we'll be going to Dallas to compete in nationals, which we got second. We got second place against IAEA, who won Hawaii. So we did fairly great last year.
Incredible job. We'll let you go ahead and join your teammates, and we'll take a look at some of the cheerleading from the Broken Arrow squad. The squad, as you said, was the state champions a year ago and have done an outstanding job. As we said, over 10,000 people will for sure be here tonight to witness history in the making, the first game in Broken Arrow's Memorial Stadium. Andy Irwin gives us a better look at the facilities.
Tigers don't take to the air, but the entire Broken Arrow community is flying high thanks to their new multi-million dollar football stadium. This 10,000 seat facility is state of the art.
It's an awesome site, and it's it's going to be more than just a place for athletic events. I think it's going to be, for Broken Arrow, one of those high points that will draw all kinds of activities out there. But obviously the football nights are going to be special.
BA knows that it very easily could have scheduled a pushover of an opponent for tonight's home opener. But these guys didn't do that. In fact, the Tigers aren't even using the stadium factor as motivation for this game.
Anytime we play, there's plenty of incentive to win. If this stadium could block and tackle, we'd suit it up and let it play, that's for sure. But it boils down to 11 young men at a time, and they're going to have to play their hearts out.
So for the first time since 1946, the yellow and black won't be taking to this field, Kirkland Field. It's a great place to watch and to play football games. But the two downfalls of playing here is that the school is all the way across town, and that as a community, Broken Arrow had just gotten too big for this old stadium.
When you look at this and you look at all the advantages that this offers, there's no comparison whatsoever. This is a beautiful facility, the all-weather surface. We can practice when it rains. Anything but lightning, we could be out here practicing. We can use it 365 days a year, and it's just a great facility. A facility we're proud of, and while we'll miss Kirkland, we need to build our own traditions and have our own great memories here.
And the Tigers would like nothing more than for that first memory to be of beating the Redskins, a team that not only beat them twice last year, but won by only 1 point in the playoffs thanks to this block kick by Jerome Janae. You have to go back to 1989 to find the last BA team that beat Union.
Really, it's just a continuance of last year, I think. You know, I mean, I feel that we should have won that, and that's what we're after, the win, not I mean, it's great to have a new stadium, but that's not what we care about.
We look for ways all during 2 days to find that 2 points that we needed to get the job done. And we've done some things that we think give us an advantage toward achieving that goal. And it is a difficult loss, and it's a loss that sticks in your craw, and it's the only thing that can make you feel better is to avenge it, and that's what we're here to do tonight.
BA has lost 13 of the last 16 meetings between the two. But maybe, just maybe, this new slice of football heaven is what the Tigers have been missing.
Man, a remarkable facility. About $8 million in all, I guess, to put all of this together. But there's more. Max Smith, the president of the Board of Education from Broken Arrow, is here with us. This money has not only gone to this, but has gone to a new school and many other things, too.
Yes, we're real proud of our new stadium. It's not only for the school, but it's for the community. And this will give us a chance to showcase some community events, our band, as well as our sports teams. It'll give a great venue for soccer as well as football. And we're really looking forward to using it.
That's something great about this new artificial surface that has just come out. Nebraska got it last year. Now all of a sudden we've got four or five facilities around our state that have got it this year. And the thing that makes it good is, like you said, the band can take advantage of it, soccer, many other sports and activities.
We have an additional pad on the field, too, so to cut down injuries. This surface reportedly has almost eliminated injuries, the type of injuries you normally associate with artificial turf. So that's going to be an added advantage to us, too.
Sounds good. I appreciate you taking time for us, and all the people in Broken Arrow appreciate the effort that you've made for making this possible.
We appreciate the community, because without them, we wouldn't have this fine facility.
Well, thank you very much, Max Smith, the president of the Board of Education. Of course, we appreciate all of you people joining us live on Thursday night. More high school football action coming up next. It's the best in high school football from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Broken Arrow's Tigers hosting the number two team in the state of Oklahoma, the Union Redskins, who, of course, destroyed Clovis, California, as we showed you a little bit earlier. Want to tell you about tomorrow night's game. Of course, Thursday nights are live here in the Tulsa area. Friday nights live from Oklahoma City. We bring you the best in high school football. We'll have for you Edmond and Edmond North, taking a look at them practicing, getting ready for this one. Should be an exciting game. Last week, Norman and Norman North headed a little bit farther to the north. Edmond Memorial taking on Edmond North, statewide, free to all Cox Cable customers. Should be a lot of excitement. The Oklahoma Sooners, of course, live on pay-per-view through Cox Cable. Last week, you saw them just destroy the University of Texas, El Paso. Look at Ronaldo Works, 3 touchdowns, 98 yards on 19 carries. He was absolutely phenomenal. You can see OU football again on pay-per-view Saturday against Arkansas State. $24.95 is your cost, and you can call 665-0200 at Cox Communications for more information. Also, the University of Tulsa taking on Oklahoma State. We know what a great rivalry this is, especially the home team does so well. Tulsa's caused Oklahoma State tremendous difficulties in Skelly Stadium, and that's where the game will be Saturday, September 9th. The University of Tulsa taking on Oklahoma State in Oklahoma City. You can see that on Channel 3 in Tulsa on Channel 9, live only for Cox Cable customers once again. Of course, we talked about the Broken Arrow facility, the Broken Arrow Stadium that's right here. Union has been a dominant team in the state of Oklahoma. Benny Dixon now joins us. Pardon me for talking over the national anthem at the moment. It's just about over. Benny, this facility is awesome, but you guys have also made improvements to a remarkable facility you have at Union.
Yeah, we're proud of our facilities, but I'm so proud for Ken Ellett and their athletic department and the city of Broken Arrow for stepping up and making a mark for everybody to shoot for. This is a fabulous facility, and now our minds are thinking how we can improve ours even better than what it is.
It is amazing, the competition that goes on in Oklahoma, and we found out last week how good our brand of football is by the showing you guys put on Clovis.
Yeah, we thought we'd bring in the best in California, but apparently the brand of football may not be what it is here in eastern Oklahoma. So we'll go out there next year, and if we can do that next year, maybe we are better than California.
Something that's interesting, too, you've got brand new uniforms, and the brand new uniforms just about didn't get here, but they are here and they're ready.
Yeah, about 2:35 this afternoon they showed up, so we've got them on the kids. We're excited. They always like the new unis, so this is a new white jersey that we always bring out for a big rival. Either Jinx or Broken Arrow, for some reason, always gets our new uniforms.
Sounds good. Benny Dixon, appreciate you being with us, the Union Athletic Director. Of course, Union has done a remarkable job. They just destroyed Clovis, California. Andy Irwin gives us a closer look at exactly what happened 6 days ago.
For years, high school football has crossed state lines in pursuit of newer and bigger challenges. But Union football is going a step further. They look for their competition 1,500 miles away. Last week, the Skins hosted Clovis, California, and put the pride of both states on the line.
We're multiple formations, quite a bit like Union. As far as X's and O's are concerned, Union's got some excellent football players to make that offense work.
But the coach from Clovis was wrong. His California boys were nothing like the Redskins.
Well, to our advantage, they ran the same offense that our offense does, a one back, a lot of shotgun. And we face our offense every day, so we're used to the one back shotgun. So that played our side, I think, a lot.
This game was 4 years in the making, and Union will return the favor next year as they travel to the coast to play Clovis again. This home-and-home series says a lot about where high school football is headed. It's always been the most popular, but somehow keeps getting bigger and better.
It's happening more and more. A lot of people don't understand it, aren't familiar with it. You know, our band does this kind of thing every year. They travel all over, our cheerleaders. You know, football is one of the sports that traditionally hasn't done a lot of traveling. When we went to our superintendent, she just told us that she thought it'd be a great idea, but we'd have to be willing to raise the money just like the band and other people do, and not depend on the school to send us. So we're doing that, and our kids are excited about it.
But maybe just as impressive as playing a team from California was the defensive shutout of an honest-to-goodness West Coast offense. A big donut on the scoreboard is something all coaches like to see.
Oh, you bet. Our defensive staff did a great job, Coach Fav and his guys were well prepared. Our defense played very hard, very aggressively, had a lot of tackles behind the line. You know, when you can come out of there with negative yards in the rushing category, you got to feel real good.
Well, the coaches hadn't talked too much about it. They expect us to get a shutout every game. That's what they expect of us. We really don't get any treats for it or anything, just the, you know, self-pride that we did the job right, so that's enough.
And all the defensive coaches, I think, spend all weekend. I think their wives get real mad at them because they're all there all the time. And they're there from right after the game till start of practice on Monday, just watching game film the team we're about to play.
But this week's test is totally different from the Californians. Broken Arrow plays smash mouth football. Instead of defending a passing attack, the Tigers will come by land, a team known for their option football.
Welcome back to Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. The largest school in the state of Oklahoma, Broken Arrow, hosting for the first time in its brand new Memorial Tigers Stadium, the number two team in the state, nationally ranked Union Redskins. This is an intense rivalry like very few others. Take a look at some of the people coming in, the parachutists just now landing on the field, at least some of them. There are more that are on the way. Incredible festivities going on in this $8 million facility. It's a beautiful night in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, located just outside to the east of Tulsa, Oklahoma. $8 million for the facility, brand new turf as well. It's artificial turf, just exactly like Oklahoma State has. It's AstroPlay, made by the company AstroTurf out of Texas. Beautiful look at it right there that Andy Irwin's given us a look at. It's a little bit thicker than the grass that's at TU and also at Jinx. It's plush, it's beautiful, rubber matched in between. It's going to be a great football game tonight. Perfect weather, perfect conditions, and we're going to have it all for you. The only place that you can watch is on Cox Cable, the best of live high school football, the only place to see live high school football. Thursday nights in Tulsa, Friday nights in Oklahoma City. We've got the best in the state, maybe the best game in the country, coming up for you next. The Broken Arrow Tigers taking on the Union Redskins. First ever game here in a sold-out stadium. 10,000 5 feet sitting and plenty of more people standing. It's going to be spectacular.
The extra point to send send it to another overtime. He kicked the field goal. What about the PAT? It's blocked. But I heard a whistle. Let's see. No. It's blocked and the game is over.
I see no flag.
Union has won it on a blocked extra point kick in overtime.
This live event featuring members of the Oklahoma Secondary School Activities Association is an exclusive presentation of Cox Communications, your home for the 2000 5A and 6A State Football Championship.
Welcome to our game of the week as the Union Redskins travel to Broken Arrow to take on the Tigers in the 17th meeting between the two state-ranked teams. Welcome to Broken Arrow as we get set for week number two. It's the Union Redskins getting set to take on the Tigers, a steep history between the two schools. Hello again, Don King, along with J.V. Haney. Welcome to week number two of the prep season. When you look at these two teams, first of all, you think of what the Tigers accomplished last year, and they lost a very talented quarterback in Mickey Nickel.
Oh, they really did, because Mickey Nickel was such a leader, Don, and he really led the ball club, went to the quarterfinals, and lost that heartbreaker over at Union, a great quarterback in the loss of Mickey Nickel.
Nickel, a three-year starter. He's replaced by this young man, Doug Clendenning.
And it just depends upon how quickly Doug can adapt himself to the flexbone offense that Coach Jones runs. But I know this, the coaching staff is very confident in his ability.
He had a good game last week in their 14-0 win over Sepulpa. And on the other side, a guy that had his coming out party last year was Tyler Gooch for Union against BA.
And really, Tyler Gooch is a two-dimension player. He can throw it and he can run it. And more importantly, he's an outstanding leader at the quarterback position.
There are his numbers last week in the win over Clovis, California. We're coming back with the opening kickoff from the brand new BA Stadium, and we continue in a moment. And you couldn't ask for a better way to start week number two of the 2000 football season than open a new stadium that was long time in the making here in Broken Arrow. As you see the home side, that will seat some 6,500 here at Tiger Field, 2,300 reserve tickets, and JV, they already have 400 to 500 on a waiting list, so they think before the season's over, they might have to expand that, as you see the number two ranked Redskins coming out, as Benny Dixon pointed out, in their new uniforms.
Beautiful new uniforms there, the Union, and they have a lot of luck, as Benny said, with the white uniforms on the road when they're able to play it in the new one. But Don, when you look at this stadium, it is full, and there are people standing around, and that's kind of a tradition from the old football stadium to have them standing along the sideline, and the atmosphere here tonight is just, it's very similar to the Skelly Stadium Union Jinx game for the state playoff championship.
And the Tigers get ready to come out under head coach Rick Jones. Two coaches that are certainly familiar to the Oklahoma City market, both having coached at Edmond at one time, and I always joke with each of them because whenever Rick Jones leaves Broken Arrow, Bill Blankenship will be the next coach, because Blankenship had followed Jones at Edmond and then followed Blankenship, or rather Blankenship had followed Jones then on to Union. We are on the outskirts of Broken Arrow, as you might have been able to tell from that shot. There are the 11 trainers that Broken Arrow has on their staff, and the Tigers unveiling new home uniforms for the year 2000. There's a look at Bill Blankenship. Ninth year as the head coach at Union. He's taken them to the state championship three times in the 90s.
66-19 going into tonight's game for Bill Blankenship, and that's a great record as far as his tenure with 8 years at Union is concerned.
Well, let's talk about some of the players while we have a chance. As you take a look at Coach Blankenship, Union, their big playmaker is number one, Jerome Janae. As you take a look at Rick Jones, who just celebrated his 100th win as a head coach, again starting at Edmond. Longtime assistant in the Oklahoma City area, was at Edmond, taking them to the 89 state championship, where they beat Tulsa, Washington 23-6. And then came to Union, a few years in Southwest Missouri, and now at BA. Let's go downstairs to Jack Bunce.
Just about ready for the opening kickoff. As you can see, Union's out on the field. We're just waiting for Broken Arrow to get out there and kick things off. As you pointed out, Union has brand new uniforms. The thing that's interesting, they got them at 2 o'clock. Manufacturers told them there's a little bit of a defect with their uniforms. Don't be surprised if some of them come a little bit undone. Now, they look like they're well put together. The players, the staff think they are, but the manufacturer a little bit worried that we might have some tearaway jerseys tonight. So could be an interesting ball game for the Union Redskins.
Deep four, Union is 23 on the far side. Ramsey Stevens and Keith Ford, a backup defensive back. And they await at about the 15-yard line. Aaron Sanders will do the kicking. You saw him in the pregame show and some of our tape from last year's state quarterfinal game, which, again, Union won that game in the overtime, 34-33. And Jerome Janae with the extra point block to send Union to the state semifinals, where they won in Stillwater and advanced to the finals last year. Well, the new stadium is underway, and Sanders gets it off in a good way, as that will be an automatic touchback. And there is Mark Garner, the offensive line coach of the Union Redskins, to see how his offensive line will do, JB. And to me, that's one of the questions of this Union team. As you take a look, a brand new, all five new starters, four seniors and a sophomore. Gooch is the returning starter, a new running back in Trinity Dawson. And look at the four receivers. Janae is the big playmaker. Chisholm played quarterback as a backup last year. And Caleb Blankenship is the second of three sons of the head coach. First down from the 20. Broken Arrow always stout on defense. They give one up to Janae, and he's a big playmaker across the 35, near the 38-yard line. And that's a first down and a good start for the Redskins.
And that shows you just how quick Tyler Gooch can get that ball out there.
Let's take a look at the Broken Arrow defense, who shut out Sepulpa last week. Cook, Wilhite, and Rogers returned from a year ago. Cook will go both ways. Linebackers are good with Condry and Tovar on the outside. Frazier, maybe their best defensive player from a year ago. Florentine is the only returning starter in the secondary. Gain of 14 on the last play, and Gooch has time again. Squares it out. Fumble, and the Tigers have it across midfield. Looked like it was number 10, Adam Ray, out of the secondary that covered it up.
That was a nice quick-hitting pass. Senator Caleb Blankenship, he goes out and makes a little route, sideline route. Caught the ball, but looked like he just maybe started to run, Don, a little bit too soon. He's got it in his hands, but just never really maybe had complete control. Oh, that's just a great play in there by Philip Tolver. He came right around and just knocked the ball out. Great play defensively.
Tolver is a returning starter from a year ago. Here's Doug Clendenning. We talked about hit at the opening. He wants to open it upstairs and throws it incomplete. Looking for the intended receiver, Hamill, Jamison Hummel, the junior wide receiver. Let's take a look at the Broken Arrow offense. Saw Arnold and Cook on the defensive line. There's a look at the rest of the offensive line. Four seniors and a junior. Dee Dorsey at running back in place of the injured Keith Jacobs. Shane Jones returns from fullback a year ago. And three new receivers. After the incomplete pass, this is Clendenning, who had a good game last week, including one of the two touchdowns for BA. And he's at midfield, sitting up third down and long. There's Steve Spavital, the defensive coordinator of the Union Redskins, whose son is on the defense. A very good defensive line. Barnes had four sacks last week. Rooney and Guzman, about as good as it gets in the interior defense. Mansfield and Dupree are outstanding. Ramey and Spavital return, as well as Gibson from a year ago. Janae played sparingly on defense last year. He'll get a lot of defense this year. 44 in the backfield is Shane Jones, who was out last week with a concussion. Clendenning near the first down marker. He's probably going to be 2 yards shy, and that'll set up a fourth down.
Well, we're getting a good look here at the flexbone offense, is the option that is run by Rick Jones and the Broken Arrow Tigers, and they do an excellent job of it. But good lateral movement down here by the Union defense as they move down the line as well, and Billy Ramey making the tackle there.
They're just inside the 45-yard line. About 8 yards on the run, and here's the punt from Broken Arrow hitting near the 20. Boy, it doesn't get much bounce on this artificial surface, does it? We'll talk about that as we move along. Union has it just inside the 20 as they get the ball back. 2 minutes gone in the game. Don King, J.B. Haney, welcome you back. Let's go down to Jack.
We've had one possession for each of these teams so far. No score thus far. Union had a turnover. Broken Arrow unable to pick up a first down. Showing you the scoreboard in the background because both offenses having trouble clicking. We almost didn't have a scoreboard clicking. They had no electricity this morning. Great job by the Broken Arrow personnel to get electricity in here so they could get everything working in time tonight.
Thank you, Jack. 27 feet high for the scoreboard, 36 feet wide at the south end of the stadium, $140,000 for the stadium, or for the scoreboard that was paid for by the sponsors who are on the scoreboard. So after the 25-yard punt by Aaron Sanders, Tyler Gooch gets his offensive unit back, first and 10 from the 19. You saw the state championship game a year ago. You saw the exploits of this young man who had his coming out party a year ago against BA. And they beat the Tigers 31-9, and Gooch was outstanding. This is Dawson looking for a hole, and he'll get lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. You see 89, Mike Condry, the linebacker, and I believe also in there was 59. You'll see a lot of him tonight as well. Josh Rogers, the two-year starter at defensive end.
And Rogers only a sophomore, but he's certainly made a name for himself on defense. Don, I think it's interesting to look at the number of seniors. Union starts 10 seniors on offense and 11 seniors on defense. So when you see a senior-dominated team, you know that you've got a lot of experience there on the field with you.
Broken Arrow starts six seniors, four juniors, and a sophomore on offense. Defensively, seven seniors, two juniors, two sophomores. And there is big 75, two-year starter, another one of the big seniors, Jason Wilhite, wrapping up Dawson after he picks up 3 yards to the 23-yard line. Union last week, JV, knocked off Clovis, California, 36-0, and had 248 yards rushing.
The Broken Arrow defense really coming across the line and coming off the ball well, putting the pressure on the quarterback, and I think you're going to start seeing putting it up in the air now, maybe that those last two plays had very little on the ground, picking up, what, about 4 yards?
Yeah. One of the advantages of this field is the play clock, which had 7 left. When Gooch got the snap, boy, they're playing off that young man a little bit too much. Jerome Janae, you can't blame them. Casey Jones there to make sure Janae had a knee down up at the 38-yard line. That's a gain of 15.
And that's a big third down play, but if you'll notice Jerome Janae here, he'll run right at Casey Jones, making back off, and then he'll run a little curl pattern. Came right down and caught it, didn't trap it, came and caught it in his arms. That's just a good offensive route.
I'm going to be interested to see, Coach, how these two teams run against each other, because Union's offensive line, very new. Broken Arrow's defensive line, very much experienced and pretty good size for them as in past years, compared to past years. There's a hole, though, and just tripped up from behind, making the tackle was 21, Chris Henson. That might have gone for a lot further. As it is, it'll be about 9 or 10 yards on the run.
You get those misdirection plays like that, and Trinity Dawson really hit the hole well. He comes off the guard pulling there, getting a nice block at the line of scrimmage, and picked up just a good gain, almost enough for a first down.
Now they're going to measure. Tyler Gooch, a very good baseball player. He was an outfielder as a sophomore. Last year, I believe he played third base and has been at least a 350 hitter in his career for Union for baseball. And Mark Garner, the offensive line coach whom you got a shot of earlier, is the baseball coach. There's Rick Jones out of Ardmore. Dawson did get 10, so it's first down. Here are the numbers of Gooch from a week ago. They're in Broken Arrow, or near Broken Arrow territory at the 48. Gooch, quick pitch. Dawson, nice move across midfield. He'll pick up about 5 or 6 yards. A lot of black shirts, as is usual the case, for the state-ranked Tigers.
I think it's interesting as you watch the both offenses work and the defense try to make the adjustments, but when they were taking the ball between the tackles, it was very difficult. Now they come back and they run an option play here, and just an outstanding job in there by the running back, Trinity Dawson. And They have a lot of weapons, Union offense does.
John Frazier, number 62, polished Dawson off. Frazier is a three-year starter at defensive end and now linebacker. 5'11", 220-pound senior. In fact, Frazier had a big play last year in the state playoffs against Stillwater when he picked up
defense,
a fumble
and
went about 50 yards.
The down remains the same.
It gave Broken Arrow 21-19 playoff win over Stillwater, and then, of course, Broken Arrow lost to this Union team at Tuttle Stadium last year in overtime. 5-yard penalty, first of the game. That'll go against the Broken Arrow Tigers. In this series, this is the 17th meeting between the two schools. As we get another first down. And Union has won 11 in a row and lead the series 13-3. Some of the games have been spectacular. And this one at the new stadium. Screen pass set up beautifully. And Dawson's got people in front. To the 30-yard line before Trinity Dawson is brought down. He's at the first down marker. And the Redskins are moving the chains. Scoreless here midway through the first quarter.
And again, you're seeing an awful lot of flexibility within the offense. That's a nice screen pass in there to the big running back. Great blocking out front set up for it. And again, you're seeing such a variety of passes that is being done here by the offense for Union.
You saw Blake Smith, 72, lead the way. He's one of the two sophomores starting on offense for Union. Gain of 11, so it's another first down. Tovar pressuring. Gooch out of the pocket, and he's caught from behind. And 58, Tom Arnold, who goes both ways, 6'5", 235 senior. Offensive right tackle, defensive tackle, makes the stop just inside the 30, and we'll give him a yard on that play.
Here we get another look at just how quick Tyler Gooch is. He sees that opening. He's got to go somewhere. He doesn't get a gain, but he gets it back to the line of scrimmage without a loss, and that's about all you can expect in that situation.
Actually, no gain on the play part, so it is second and 10. Gooch has been masterful here in the early going. He hasn't thrown an incompletion yet. He's completed his first four passes. Dawson, though, looking for a hole, gets hit at the line of scrimmage. And who else but 62, John Frazier. We'll see a lot of him tonight. He had six tackles last week at Sepulpa in the 14-0 win over the Chieftains.
When Jerome Janae, number one for Union, Don, splits out the way he does, and with his speed, he really creates a lot of problem for the defensive back because he can run that curl pattern so effectively. He gets him just backpedaling a little bit. He'll make that turn, and then I tell you what, Caleb Blankenship has given him a lot of help as receiving also.
Out of the shotgun, they load up, trips left. Janae to the right. He's there. He's got it, and that's a touchdown for the second-ranked Union Redskins. He is some kind of playmaker. He realized, I think, very late in the season just how good he could be to show you that he not only plays offense, he plays defense, as we told you, and on special teams, he blocked six kicks last year and a couple last week.
Well, he did then what we were talking about. If you get up, he'll blow by you. He has so much speed, so you kind of have to guess which way to go.
Extra point kick is good by Jake Gibbons, and with 5 minutes to go, first quarter, Union's on the board. There's a look at the scoring drive. According to our statistician, Jeff Dunn, he's right on. 9 plays, 81 yards, and the scoring strike, 28-yarder to Jerome Janae. And Tyler Gooch in this first quarter is 5 of 5, and Janae has 3 catches already here in the early going for 57 yards. Well, to the other side of the ball, D.D. Dorsey, the junior running back, awaits the kickoff. Gibbons with the kick and Dorsey at the goal line. And it is not Dorsey, but the other man deep. That is Matt McCoy, the backup running back, and he is just shy of the 20-yard line. On the tackle, 44, starting linebacker Josh Dupree. We'll see a lot of him on defense as well.
Josh Dupree is one of the sought-after D1 linebackers in the state of Oklahoma this year. He was good last year and has gotten better this year.
There's a look at Clendenning, Coach. What's it I mean, you just got to have a lot of patience when you think about a quarterback getting his first start of the season on the road and then coming in here first start at home in a brand new stadium. Nice job there as he runs out of bounds near the 30. He'll be shy of the first down. This kid can run the football, and that's what Broken Arrow has loved to do for years out of this flex bone, JV, is have a quarterback that can run to the outside.
And, you know, it really looks like here that Doug Clendenning, he is going to get better as the season goes, but he's not afraid to carry the football. And you see him there just ducking. He gets as much as he possibly can. But running that flex bone offense where you have the option, why, he looks like the type of quarterback, as I said, that will improve every game.
Now the question is, can the Tigers' offensive line move Union out a bit? And they do. And Shane Jones really came on at the end of last year. Big fullback. I think he's probably the best fullback in the area. Makes the first down run.
Well, this is really a test for the offensive line for Broken Arrow, because this veteran team, 11 seniors coming back on defense, they've got their work cut out for them, but they'll know just how good they are when this game is over.
A lot of people in the backfield. Clendenning looks for help and slides through across the 35. He'll pick up about five. Clendenning's numbers last week against Sepulpa, he was 1 of 6 passing. But more importantly, 21 rushes, 113 yards, and a touchdown. We take a look.
Well, he shows you right here that when he sees daylight that he's going to go. And that kind of reminds you, Mickey Nickel had that same type of courage with the football, didn't he?
It was a battle between three quarterbacks in the preseason. They settled on Clendenning. He won his opener last week. This is McCoy, who had the kickoff return, and there's Josh Dupree, 44, on the tackle. This Union team defensively has some stalwarts, especially 90 there, the defensive lineman Rooney, Guzman, 92. They anchor that defensive line, and then you've got some pretty good linebackers in Dupree and Mansfield, 32.
Matt McCoy really followed me. He's blocking there across the line of scrimmage and picking up a couple of 3 extra yards just through great effort.
Another guy to look for tonight is number 30, Zach Spavital. They're going to measure to see if McCoy got the first down. Spavital, number 30, is a guy that we'll not only see on defense but also special teams. He is their punter and returns punts. There's Spavital, number 30. Jack says it's a first down by 4 inches. And it is.
Tell you what, Jack Buns is right on top of it.
This is an artificial turf, as Jack pointed out in the pregame, that is known as Astro Play. That's the same as what Oklahoma State will unveil in Stillwater next week. Patrons here in Broken Arrow, for those that might be watching around the state, had to pass 2 bond issues and then get a $1.9 million contract from Pepsi to finally get this thing going. And they have done so. Nothing doing here in the backfield, and there's a loss back to the 40. And Clendenning sacked and had nowhere to go.
That's that great aggressive defense once again in there. The front four putting a lot of pressure, the linebackers shooting. Clendenning doesn't have much of an opportunity to get out of that situation.
Not when you got Chris Barnes, the defensive end, waiting on you, the 6'3", 215-pound senior. He had 12 tackles a week ago. There's Mike Ryan, 96. So after the loss, Clendenning has to go upstairs for the first time. Incomplete. Actually, the second time. His first offensive play was an incomplete pass. There's Bill Blankenship showing off his arm. He was a quarterback at TU in 77 and 79, led the Golden Hurricane in passing. Grew up in Spiro, and that young man, Rick Jones from Broken Arrow, grew up in Ardmore, as I mentioned earlier.
Two outstanding high school football coaches on the field tonight, Don.
Both know what it takes to get to the state championship game. Third down and 14 from the 40. Clendenning, a little pitch to McCoy, and he's lucky to hang on to it. He got belted by Darryl Mansfield, the linebacker, who is a senior. His first start as a sophomore was in the state semifinals against Lawton a couple of years ago, and McCoy comes off failing to get the first down.
Now here's that little shuffle pass. You're going to see it, but great, just absolutely playing it perfectly was the linebacker in there, Darryl Mansfield, who just looked like Don. Maybe he anticipated exactly what that play was.
Back to punt is Aaron Sanders. His first punt was good for 25 yards. He averaged about 35 a week ago. And this guy is dangerous. Spavital. He is knocked down, though, by 62 Frazier. 2:22 to go opening period. The Redskins have the ball back, leading 7-0. We're coming back in a minute to Broken Arrow. Stay with us. Look at Brian Frazier, the defensive coordinator of the Broken Arrow Tigers, trying to get his defense going. JB, it's an interesting story with this Broken Arrow coaching staff. Rick Jones, as late as July, was looking for four assistant coaches. He lost three to the state of Texas. He tried to hire a junior high coach from Texas, and that guy would have had to take a pay cut to come to Oklahoma. So I want your comments on Oklahoma coaches, and there were some in the Oklahoma City area exiting Oklahoma for Texas. First down from the 21-yard line after the 30-yard punt. And Gooch hands off to Dawson. He's getting a lot of work here in the early going, and he shows you why as he gets the first down run here. Trinity Dawson, who was in the shadow of Jason York a year ago.
Just some good blocking on that right offensive side of the line for the Union Redskins, giving Dawson the opportunity to pick up the first down. Now, when you talk, here we get a good look at it. You see a great block set in there by Justin Brown, one of them, and just break him loose. Good hard run. You talk about the Texas coaches, Don. There was something like, I think, 20 coaches that left out of the state of Oklahoma going to Texas this year, and that happens almost every year. And it's simply because less teaching load, higher pay, and better benefits.
Has it become rather alarming because we are losing so many coaches to Texas?
Well, I don't know.
There are a few that come back occasionally.
Yeah, I don't know where you would say it's alarming or not, but there's just a lot of good coaches leaving, and maybe in 10 years you'll be able to tell the difference because of the quality that is leaving. That would, like on the assistants, they would be head coaches in the near future, and they'll be head coaches now in the state of Texas.
Second down and 7. There is a look at the home side. 6,500 strong on the home side, 3,500 on the far side. So we have at least 10,000 and plenty of standing room only. And look at this. Is he open again? Can he go all the way? You bet. Touchdown again, Jerome Janae. They're going to bring it back, though. Don Hammack is the referee, and I'll let JB run down the rest of the officials tonight, but he's saying, come on back, boys, we got a flag.
Really have a veteran crew here tonight. Don Hammack's the referee, William Parker's the umpire, John Allison the linesman, Don Stewart the line judge, and Charles Brown is a back judge, and you add up their years of experience in officiating high school football in Oklahoma, and it comes to 99 years, Don. So this is truly a veteran crew.
Mark Garner can't believe one of his guys was
15
called
yards,
for the illegal
replay
block.
The down.
So the touchdown is taken off the board. They haven't yet, with a minute 11 remaining on the first quarter clock. Redskins still lead 7-0.
Hard to pick up who the penalty was called on, but, you know, kind of coming out of the shotgun right there. And again, Janae is just so fast that he... If you expect him to do the curl, he blows past you, and he did that time for what seemed like going to be the second touchdown to call back with a penalty. A great move by him.
You see, they really spread the offense out, so it's pretty tough to double cover Janae when you got so many other receivers. Dawson, nice dancing out to the 25, 30, near the 40-yard line. Well, this young man is making a name for himself. Union throughout the 90s has had 1,000-yard rushers. Dawson last week had a pretty decent game. He led Union in running the football. Actually, McIlvain led with 77 yards. Dawson behind him with 68.
See a great block in there by the big end, Brock Grunberg. He really broke him loose at the line of scrimmage. And, you know, once you get Dawson out there, he's good enough on his own to make the yardage.
The good news for Broken Arrow is that he didn't make a first down. Bad news, though, it's third and about four. And they don't make it on third down. Gooch trying the sneak. Nothing doing. The interior defense for Broken Arrow waiting for him.
Well, even though they didn't get the touchdown, I think that gives the offense a lot of confidence, Don, that they're able to move the football against the Broken Arrow defense.
That young man is Justin Fjorntine, senior defensive back who waits the punt. And he'll have to wait until after the end of the first quarter break. So after one period, the Union Redskins, ranked number 2, lead the 8th-ranked Tigers 7-0. Don King, J.B. Haney, and Jack Buns, along with our producer Paul McFarland, the rest of our Cox Communications crew, welcoming you to Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. It is a town of 70,000-plus now. It's the fifth-largest community in Oklahoma. Zach Spavital with the second punt of the game, and Fjorntine lets it hit at the 25, and look at this roll. Inside the 10-yard line. Everything working well in the first half, except for a couple of untimely penalties for the Union Redskins. Downing that was Keith Ford, and Broken Arrow will set up shop inside their 10, down by 7. Here's our TulsaSportsWeb.com trivia question. Which high school quarterback was the last to throw 5 touchdown passes in a playoff game? Oh, some pretty good QBs right there. Justin Fuente from Union, Blankenship from Union, Nickel from Broken Arrow, or Mike Gundy from Midwest City. Just get online and give us your vote. Shane Jones breaks loose, and Jones across the 15-yard line. And that's a first down, or close to it. Nope, a yard shy, I beg your pardon, of the first down marker for the Broken Arrow Tigers.
One thing you notice about this new surface down here, Don, it's very soft, and it seems like that in watching them practice and their practice punting, they weren't getting the bounce off from it that you get sometimes off of natural grass. Very soft turf, very comfortable turf.
Jake Gibbons, the cornerback on the stop after a gain of 7. Jones again, look at the quick opening by the BA offense, and that's a first down from the big fullback, Shane Jones, 5'11", 190.
Shane Jones hits that line, and he hits it quick. Good blocking up front by the offensive line.
Do you like this field, JB, after traipsing on it before the game?
You know, it just feels like you want to run, jump, and play on it. I mean, yes, I think it's a very inviting surface, and it feels so comfortable as you walk, and you've got good traction as you cut. Yes, I like it.
Jones again, look at him, still working. Working those legs, and he gets across the 25 to the 28. That's good for a half dozen. And Shane Jones and that offensive line of the BA Tigers now starting to exert themselves early in the second quarter, trailing by 7.
And you can see the Broken Arrow definitely wants to try to keep the Union defense on the field as much as they possibly can and take as much out of them as they can, because it's still a little warm here, but most of the kids are pretty well in condition that shouldn't be a factor.
Center is Mike Cook. 2-year starter, senior snaps to Clendenning. They're just working Shane Jones, and Jones works his way to move the chains again up near the 35-yard line.
That flexible offense can hit very, very quickly, and Shane Jones, he's almost at top speed on his second step, Don, so he's able to hit that hole. That's just a great block in there by Chris Ryder. He really opened the hole.
Well, watch the player's footing. You saw Jones try to make a cut there and looked as though it gave a little bit on him. So we'll watch that.
Well, it almost looks like it feels like it's real grass.
Oh, yeah. It's a little softer than what you would get on a natural surface. That didn't look like it got much, but it ends up getting 3 yards. And a look at the quarterback there, Doug Clendenning. There's Aaron Rooney, 3-year player for the Redskins, 6'2", 267.
Both of these schools always have a good running back, and Shane Jones looks like he's going to be the one to step in this year for the Tigers.
We'll get a look at the stats later. Clendenning looking, got a man. Did he catch it? He did. First down, Broken Arrow, and they're in Union territory for the first time. And you can thank the sophomore, Jason Ray, the only sophomore starting on the offense.
And Jason Ray, much like Jerome Janae, just got out and just absolutely outran Keith Ford, the defender there, and a nice lob pass over by Clendenning completing that. That's a good hookup between the quarterback and the wide receiver.
Down to the Union 38. So from the Broken Arrow 38 to the Union 38. That's good for 24. And a Tiger first down with 9 minutes to go first half. Jones again. Or rather, it's Clendenning after the fake to Jones. And that'll set up second down and long. Look at Billy Ramey.
Billy Ramey comes in out of his defensive back position. He blitzes in there, and he was able to slow him down, and where eventually he was tackled by Pete Knapp, but it was Ramey that started it. Just great pressure on the quarterback.
No gain on the play. Second down and 10. That's what Union wants to do, is try to put Broken Arrow into an ultimate passing situation. And Clendenning, you saw him dive. He tried to get all he could. Actually, Dupree caught him from behind and tied his legs up. But Clendenning, using great effort by diving forward for a couple of extra yards. Let's go down to Jack.
Guys that are doing the job right now, Doug Clendenning and Shane Jones, you'll notice they're not very big, 5'9", 170, 5'9", 190, yet they're two of the strongest guys on the team. Take a look at it. You wouldn't think they'd be so successful up the middle, but they're doing the job right now.
They really are, and they set up a third down and 5 from the Union 33, so an interesting play here. As they send two receivers left, slot left, so pro formation left, and Keith Jacobs in action for the first time this season, number 20, and Clendenning can find no room. It'll be fourth down, and now Rick Jones has a decision to make whether they go for it on fourth and about 5.
Michael Ryan coming in, making a nice tackle in from the corner.
I think they'll go for it. New coaches this year for Rick Jones. Trandy Birch, the offensive coordinator, calling the plays. Trandy actually played his high school ball at Union. And they are going for it. Fourth down, Clendenning has time, had time, fights for more time. And finally brought down from behind by 96, Mike Ryan, getting his first start this season, a senior linebacker slash defensive end. Clendenning did a nice job of buying as much time as he could.
You know, Michael Ryan shows you a lot of speed here. He's 6 foot, 205 pounds, but as Clendenning is scrambling all over the place, he eludes a tackle right there. It looked like they had him, but Michael Ryan just doesn't give up in pursuit, and from behind, that's just a great job. But I would defend Coach Jones if someone would think maybe he should have gone for the field goal. I think you need to give an offense and a young quarterback, inexperienced quarterback, the opportunity to do something at that point. So I think that was a good call on Rick Jones' part.
And remember, they started that drive at their own 9-yard line. So a nice effort by Broken Arrow's offense. However, on the first play, Trinity Dawson breaks loose. And he goes from his 37 to the Broken Arrow 41-yard line. That's good for 28 yards and another Union first down. So the field position they gained, they just about gave up.
And this is just some great blocking up in front. You can see him sealing both inside and outside and turning him loose. And if you'll watch when Trinity Dawson comes back into the huddle, he's patting those big linemen on the head and thanking them for giving him the opportunity. 9 attempts, 81 yards. He'll probably have a TD for the night.
Nice move there as he spins to the 35-yard line.
You know, when you have a good running back like Trinity Dawson, why, you just keep hitting him, and then with a quarterback like Gooch and someone who can fly like Jerome Janae, they'll come back and throw that bomb on you. They kind of lull you into protecting the middle and then hit you hard on the outside and deep.
They give Dawson a breather here. Let's see who they bring in. As Gooch gets a play from the sideline. Spencer McElwain has been a backup, and he is in there. He was a freshman last year that played in the state championship game. Loose ball. McElwain picks it up, and then he's downed immediately. And that's a loss of 5 yards back to the 40-yard line. Union scored the first time they got the ball on a Tyler Gooch to Jerome Janae 28-yard TD pass. With 5 minutes to go, first half. Nothing new. If you saw the state championship game last year, Union scored the first time they got the ball against Jinx on a terrific one-handed grab by Janae.
This is a very alert Spencer McElwain here. Once we got through Gooch on the ground, he picks it up. But watch him hold onto that football. He knows he's not going anywhere. Didn't try to gamble. Didn't try to do anything heroic. Just took the loss and protected the ball.
Gooch under center. Instead of the shotgun. out to McIlvain, and with 5:08 to go, the clock stops, and we'll see what Union decides to do here as they're just shy of the 35-yard line in BA territory. 45 there is Ben Lake, one of the starting linebackers, and one of the two sophomores starting on defense.
The little flare, the little bubble pass out to McIlvain, and again, I like the way the little fella holds onto that football, Don, just as the lick came that knocked him out of bounds. You saw that other hand come on the ball.
Timeout on the field. We'll take a break. We are in Broken Arrow. Glad you are with us around the state. Well, apparently Jake Gibbons is in to try a field goal. This one would be a big one, a 54-yard attempt. What a way to start. If he hits this one, the new Memorial Stadium. He had a 32-yarder a week ago. It is going to be just short. Oh, he was on the line, but just short on the 54-yard try by Jake Gibbons in his second year of kicking for Union.
That is a tremendous effort. I thought maybe it was a little wide to the left, Don, but that a very, very strong leg by Jake Gibbons in there. That will make the scouts write things down that anytime he gets inside the 35-yard line, that he's going to be a threat.
Union has controlled the game for the most part. Again, they scored the first time they had the ball. Actually, they fumbled, I beg your pardon, the first time they had the ball. In the second play of the game, Broken Arrow could not get a first down. And that's when Union went 81 yards in nine plays to lead 7-0. Broken Arrow got a couple of first downs, had to punt. Union likewise with a couple of first downs, and they traded punts. Broken Arrow's last drive went from the 9 to the Union 33. Before they ran out of downs, here they start at their own 20. Union's also had a touchdown called back because of an illegal block, a pass play, and they just missed that field goal. So Broken Arrow's dodged some bullets. They would love to get on the board here with their first touchdown at their brand new 10,000-seat stadium. Shane Jones with another hard run for about 7 yards. JB, one of the interesting things about these two schools is how these kids, some of them actually grow up across the street, but in different districts.
Well, I tell you, Shane Jones is just really giving you the greatest effort that you could possibly expect out of a running back, and it's taking two or three to bring him down every time he carries the ball. But, Don, that's a good point. I thought there was an interesting story that Lynn Jacobson had in the Tulsa World this week, talking about Rick Jones and Bill Blankenship and the kids, and it's always been a clean rivalry, and that's what you like to see.
Clendenning makes a clean move of the chains. It would appear he's near the 30. Let's see where they spot it. They're going to spot it just shy of the 30-yard line, and they're going to say he's short, so third and inches here for Clendenning and the Broken Arrow quarterback. With 4 minutes to go, first half, Union leading 7-0.
What an effort Shane Jones is giving them from the running back position. And certainly, if he continues to do that, I think you can see Doug Clendenning maybe going up in the air with a few.
That's a first down, and that'll keep the clock moving. And for the Tigers, that is their fifth first down of this half. Union has 6 to their credit. By the way, for those listening or watching, I should say, in the Tulsa market, if you are a Union fan, you can catch their games on 740 AM KRMG. And for those Broken Arrow fans, they are back on the radio. Catch their games on 100.3 FM KHJ throughout the season. Clendenning again, and he's probably going to be fortunate to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And of course, next week, the big one, Don, again in Skelly Stadium with the rematch between Union and Jinx. Should be 30,000 or more there. Clendenning once again going out and didn't make the pitch, turned up, was wrapped up in there by Aaron Rooney, big defensive lineman for the Union Redskins.
Broken Arrow's been able, although not on that last play, but they have certainly been able to move the ball a bit. And this is the big guy who has done it. Shane Jones, does he have the speed?
Janae there to catch him at the 15, and he pulls him into the end zone. Touchdown, Broken Arrow. Put it on the board. History in the making with 2:35 to go, first half.
History made there for Shane Jones, the first Broken Arrow touchdown in Memorial Stadium. And did he show you some speed, Don?
He's got a little bit more speed than some might think for his size at 5'11", near 200. Let's go downstairs to Jack as we await the extra point.
I just wanted to comment about that speed. If you'd have those two guys that were just running down the field in a track meet, you think, well, Shane doesn't have a chance against Jerome Janae. Janae couldn't catch him, number one, then couldn't bring him down. Phenomenal. 2:35 left in the half, and we're going to be tied at 7 apiece. Unbelievable.
Looked like 4-4, 4-5-40s to me.
Aaron Sanders to try to tie the game after the hold of Clendenning, the snap from Frazier, and the kick is good. A 68-yard run from Shane Jones to tie the game late in the first half. Shane Jones was their leading rusher of a year ago. He had one 100-yard game against Tahlequah. He shows you that he has some breakaway speed.
Oh, he had some great blocking that got the linebacker down, and from that point on, it was a foot race. And again, can you imagine that Shane Jones at 190 pounds, and you can see right there that Jerome Janae just can't catch him. What a race that was, and finally catches him. He takes him right on into the end zone. What a 68-yard run by Shane Jones.
So Shane Jones gets the first Broken Arrow touchdown at their brand new stadium that they started building in July of last year. And again, this stadium has been talked about and been in the works for a good 8 years. Ken Ellett's the athletic director and has been here 11. And I think you go back 8 or 9 years is when they really started talking about this facility.
Well, I think it's just wonderful that the stadiums and the facilities and the schools are improving, because competition makes everyone kind of come up another notch, and the bottom line is it's better for the kids. That's what it's all about, and what a great opportunity for the kids to play on the band, all of the drill teams. Everyone can use this facility. You don't have to worry about tearing it up or getting it muddy or killing the grass. It's just a great facility, and you just have to be proud of Broken Arrow for doing it.
Well, that's one of the things, maybe the biggest reason, is this one goes out of the end zone, so they'll start at the 20. Had it gone out of the out of bounds before it crossed the goal line, they would have marked it up at 35. But JB, bring up a good point. With it being an artificial surface, you can use this surface 300 days a year, as Union does with their artificial surface. That's the reason Jinx put in their surface, and Broken Arrow here is that now you can use it so many more times throughout the year.
Well, and you know, your junior varsity, your sophomores, your junior high kids, everyone can play on it. And again, you don't have to worry about constantly repairing the turf and watering. And cost feasibility, it is very much so.
Well, the Redskins unveil their two-minute offense. They do it about as well as anybody, and McIlvain gets a couple of yards. That's about it. The linebacker, Mike Condry, going both ways, the sophomore, makes the stop. We'll look at some of the BA fans tonight. They have supported the Tigers, win or lose. And, of course, Broken Arrow is a perennial winner, having gone to the playoffs the last 7 years.
The only thing you miss here is the tree that was at Kirkland Field that was just kind of a trademark. I'm sure they'll find a sprig from that maybe and plant it.
They took a sprig, and they I don't know that they have planted it, but they are planting. Here's Gooch, who gets out of bounds wisely to stop the clock. Just under 2 minutes remaining here in the first half. Tied at 7. Yeah, for those that are unaware, Kirkland Field seated about 6,000 if you were lucky, probably more like 550, 500. And boy, you were just right on top of the action. It was the most intimate stadium in this area. And the end zone to our right, which would be to the south, had a tree between the goalpost and the concession stand. And the kickers would kick field goals or extra points, and they would land in the tree. And kids would wait underneath the tree to watch it trickle down and try to catch it coming out of the tree. There were a few that stuck.
McElveen across the 35. And the clock continues to run. We certainly invite you to stay tuned for our halftime show, because it doesn't get any better than the Pride of Broken Arrow and the Renegade Regiment of Union to perform at halftime. It is quite a show.
McElveen, the sophomore, only 160 pounds, but he runs with like a stick of dynamite down. He just explodes through there, a hard runner for his Mountie.
He really came along toward the playoffs a year ago. This is Chisholm, Jonathan Chisholm, dragged down at the 45-yard line. Tovar makes the tackle. Chisholm was the backup quarterback a year ago, and when he came into his senior year, he certainly wanted to play more, and so they moved him to wide receiver.
It's a nice crossover pattern there by Chisholm, and just a zero pass in there by the quarterback.
And Gooch will run out of bounds, chased out by 24 Casey Jones, the defensive back, and a minute 3 remaining.
And that's smart. Get the ball out, stop the clock. Still have a minute to go, and you know one thing that Coach Blankenship, you see there on the screen, he certainly would like to get some more points if it were a field goal. And what we saw out of Jake Gibbons, Don, he'll try it there in his range maybe right now.
Yeah, 54-yarder that was online but just short a few moments ago. First down, and or rather second and 10, as Gooch ran out of bounds. One big play here, and that diving attempt inside the 30 falls incomplete, looking for Caleb Blankenship, younger brother of Josh, who of course starts at quarterback for TU. And Adam is a freshman this year. He is the last of the three Blankenship boys for Bill and his wife Angie.
Let's go, D!
Another coach's son playing besides Babatall, Coach Raider's son.
Yeah.
This year is on the Union squad as well.
Gooch, who completed his first 6 passes, actually 7. One of them taken away, a touchdown pass because of penalty. That's his first incomplete pass of the night. 6 of 7, over 100 yards. Hasn't been sacked, but he's chased out here. Wants to go deep. And overthrows incomplete. 49 seconds remaining, and there's a flag down at the line of scrimmage. I would think ineligible receiver. That's just a guess on my part, or maybe a block below the waist. Nope, ineligible receiver, because Gooch held on to it too long.
And that happens so often when you have to scramble that long, when someone gets out
downfield,
and gets downfield ready to block,
five
and
pace
the run, and then you pick out a receiver. And that time, Gooch was doing an excellent job of directing his receivers, and he was trying to get Chisholm open, but just couldn't get it to work.
They decline the penalty, make it 4th and 10 from the BA 44. Look at Rick Jones and his staff. I mentioned Trandy Birch back, Robert Pittman, Dub Maddox, John Yates, Mike Hudson, new coaches to his staff, Brian Frazier, in his first year at defensive coordinator, although I believe this is his 3rd year at BA.
Stay off the center, guys.
Back for his 5th year, former Broken Arrow defensive end. And Tim Stuckey is back for his 18th year in the system in BA, the former Owosso Ram, who has a son as backup quarterback. And for the 2nd time tonight, Zach Spavitaw has punted inside the 10-yard line. Keith Ford does the honors here with 39 seconds left. Broken Arrow will try to kill that at their own 2-yard line.
That's a great punt in there by Spavitaw. And again, Don, I think with this surface, it's the softness of it, you're not going to get the bounce that you normally would get. And that's going to give your people an opportunity to get down there and cover it as well.
Look at the numbers of first-year starter Doug Clendenning. Not bad. Clendenning, a 5'9", 170-pound junior. Beat out Zach Stuckey, who I just mentioned, and Nick Majors for the starting quarterback job. They went to Sepulpa and won last week 14-0. They open up the new stadium here, and they'll probably need to run one more play before the end of the first half. 2 big plays, one by Union in the first quarter, a 28-yarder to Jerome Janae as Kirk Frederick looks on.
You don't have to snap.
And Don Pewitt, assistant coaches for Union. Now they let the clock expire, and all 10,000 on their feet here.
as two state-ranked teams have given you your money's worth as they head to the locker room. Second-ranked Union, eighth-ranked Broken Arrow, tied at 7. Broken Arrow getting a 68-yard run with 2.5 minutes to go first half from Shane Jones. Aaron Sanders tied the game at 7. As you see, Jack Bunz set the talk with the head man of the Tigers. Jack, it's all yours.
Tell you what, Coach, new stadium, standing room only. Couldn't be a better first half for you guys.
Well, it was a good first half for us. We were a little disappointed we didn't move the ball better in the first quarter. But we sort of found our way the second quarter, and Doug did a great job. Shane made a great run, and we're in it. You know, that's what we want to be, and we know if it gets down to the fourth quarter and it's tough, we're going to be able to move the ball and have some success. It's a great night.
I might have bet the house that Shane Jones couldn't outrun Jerome Janae, but he did it tonight in the first half.
That's called motivation. Shane is a motivated player, and he plays hard. If they were in a track meet, he probably wouldn't, but out here tonight, he got it.
Congratulations. Good luck in the first half. Rick Jones, the head coach of the Broken Arrow Tigers at the half. Don and JB, anybody's ball game.
Sure looks that way, Jack. And when we come back, under the moonlight, we will take a listen and a watch to the two bands. Right now, before we get to the fans, let's take a listen and a watch here to the Broken Arrow Tigettes here at the brand new $8 million, 10,000 seat Memorial Stadium and Tiger Field. Gentlemen, the Broken Arrow Tigettes. When we come back, we'll hear from the Union Renegade Regiment as we continue from Broken Arrow, tied at halftime, 7-7. The new Broken Arrow Memorial Stadium. They had a dedication ceremony last week to dedicate the stadium and to thank all the patrons from the Broken Arrow School District. The president, if you met in the pregame show, Max Smith of the Broken Arrow Board of Education, he went to school here at VA in the 50s, was a principal here for a long time, and certainly the great work of he, Sharon Wilfley, and the rest of the VA Board of Education. Certainly appreciated here, along with the new superintendent of schools, Dr. Dennis Shoemaker, who comes from Derby, Kansas. Ken Ellett, the director of athletics.
Tonight's program
Principal
will be the opening
Kyle
second
Wood.
Of this year's competition show entitled Invasion.
Before we hear from the pride of Broken Arrow, let's hear from one of the state's best, the Renegade Regiment, under the direction of Joe Alsobrook, one of the best bands in the land.
need to go, we can fake it until they come in.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2000 Renegade Regiment.
We're here with the Union band director, Dale Barnett, and you've got to be awfully happy with the performance that your band's putting on here together tonight. It takes a lot of hard work.
Well, it's always tense right here because I always watch from up there, and this is not my greatest vantage point, but it's all right.
Tell me a little bit about exactly how long it takes for you to practice, how often you practice.
We started July 28th with like 5 hour a day rehearsals, and we practice an hour and a half every day, some sectional stuff. So we've been going about a month, 5-6 weeks already just to get this far.
Most of the practice, if not all, has to be on very hot artificial surface, so it's not only the football players that get hot.
Yeah, we're at 7 in the morning, though, and that really helps. We got the good time of the day, at least.
Coming back with much more. Stay with us. Welcome back to Broken Arrow. Let's go down to Jack Bunn's.
Got Tom Stout here, the Broken Arrow band director, and you've got to be awfully proud of your squad because 2 years ago you won a national championship at the TWA Dome, and last year, to prove it was no fluke, you won in Atlanta, and you've done very well in the state competitions too.
Yeah, we're very proud of these kids. They work very, very hard. The regional, BOA regional in St. Louis, we won twice. And in Atlanta regional, that was a great experience for us there as well. And of course, in the state, they always hold their own very, very well. So we're real pleased with them. They work hard.
Won the last few years in a row, so you've got a run going here too.
They're doing okay. We don't count our chickens. There's some awful good bands in the state. And we shoot for just a strong performance, and we go from there.
One last question I want to ask you, but as they're getting started here, not only do you play great music, but the pageantry that goes on, how do you decide and how many people does it take just to get all of that together, just the choreography and various aspects?
All right, we have a staff of 10. I have 10 people that are on my staff with me, and we start brainstorming a show like this in January, and it starts coming together in May, and then we start writing, and it goes together all summer. It's a year-long process.
Well, congratulations. Best of luck this year.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And as we usually do here at halftime, beside the bands, we take a timeout for the 180 Student of the Week.
Student of the Week. 180 Student of the Week is Broken Arrow senior Katie Fiak. Katie is recognized for her leadership and community outreach. She serves as president of her school council and volunteers with the Speech and Hearing Association to promote deaf awareness. Katie is also a member of the show choir Tiger Rhythm and maintains a 4.0 GPA. Katie Fiak is 180's
Student of the Week.
We're ready to start the second half, but before that, we'll take a timeout and come right back.
Stand by, and we are back.
Don King, J.B. Haney, Jack Bunn's with you as we get set to kick off the second half. Again, Union scoring the second time they touched the ball. Broken Arrow scored late in the first half. Let's take a look at the numbers. And believe it or not, they're fairly even. 29 plays to 28, and there's a look at the rest of the numbers.
Well, a little more rushing on the part of Broken Arrow, as we saw, and passing on the part of Union because of the big pass to Jerome Janae and the outstanding running in there by Shane Jones for the rushing yardage on Broken Arrow. But Don scores 7-7, and it's just pretty much the same.
One of those three penalties against Union cost them a touchdown, and the turnover did not. Let's take a look at some of the highlights of this first half. This is the touchdown, I believe, this is the fumble on the second play of the game. Tigers couldn't get anything going. Trinity Dawson certainly did in the first half, JV. He was impressive.
He really was, breaking tackles and just elusive, running with those strong legs.
Dawson with 87 yards in the first half running. McIlvain did most of the work, though, in the second quarter. Here's the big pass play that B.A. had to Jason Ray. Clendenning's only or second completion of the game. And here's Shane Jones busting it up 68 yards for the first touchdown for B.A. Jones' first TD of the season. He had six a year ago. We're tied at 7 before we kick off. Down to Jack.
Broken Arrow is going to get the ball to start off this second half. That's going to be critical. Keep in mind that they're going to try to do the same thing they did late in the first half. During that second quarter when Shane Jones played smash mouth football, they'll still run the option. They don't want to put the ball up. You'll notice the first half took about an hour. They play a lot of their linemen both ways. They think that, you know, they don't want fatigue to become a factor, obviously. They feel like that could help out Union a little bit because they have more guys that play just one side of the ball. So look for that smash mouth football, the ball not up in the air very much. Hang on to the football for as long as they can. Make those possessions drag out.
All right, thank you. Good work, Jack Bunz from Oklahoma's News Channel 8. This is going to be Dede Dorsey at the 15, popped at the 20, and he can go no further. DeRoy's Dorsey, who wore 21 a year ago, he now goes by Dede, and he's got BA in pretty good shape here.
Well, you know, that's a great point that Jack Bunz made. He definitely wants to keep the offense on the field as much as possible.
Look at the TulsaSportsWeb.com trivia question. You can get online and win prizes from TulsaSportsWeb.com no matter where you are around the state. Four pretty good quarterbacks there. Fuente, Blankenship, Nickel, Gunday. Give us your answer, and we'll give you the correct answer later. Does Jones do it again? Nobody in front of him. Can they catch him past midfield? Shane Jones on the run. Goodbye. Touchdown, B.A. And the Tigers score on the first play of the second half and have the lead for the first time. Tigers have ever rushed for over 200 yards in a game, and Shane Jones is knocking on that door thanks to an 80-yard scoop. And now the Tigers, so excited, I don't think they had enough on the field.
I thought that was a great comment that Coach Jones made to Jack Bunz as he went off the first half, Don, that the emotion and the motivation that Shane Jones has for this game
And that's very obvious because he, again, outrun the entire Union defense, this time for 80 yards. That's just a phenomenal effort on his part.
He was their leading rusher a year ago at 600 yards, 6 touchdowns. And he did most of that in the latter half of the year. There's Steve Spavital, the defensive coordinator, and Gary Snyder. Let's go down to Jack Bunns.
You know, I think everybody's shocked at the moment that Shane Jones just went 79 yards. Maybe the most surprising guy on the field are the guys in charge of the special teams. They forgot their tee. That's why they had to take a timeout. They didn't want to mess things up and kick it off the new carpet, so they called the tee. Oh, and now they'll get things done right.
Well, you can certainly understand the excitement of these young players. Oh, yes, this is so great for them.
Their first game, and they lead the Redskins on the first play of the second half. Sanders chips in the extra point. It was money in the bank last year. And with just 17 seconds gone, second half, Shane Jones is off to the races. Well, with Jinx and Union coming up next week, Jinx has to be licking their chops because Union's given up 2 home run plays to BA.
You know, he just kind of bounced off the left tackle in there, and evidently the corner got pulled in thinking that he was going through, bounced out, and then the speed that Shane Jones has, it's just incredible that a big fellow, 195-pounder, can run like that. Great run, great effort.
Shane Jones having some game to remember. 2 long touchdown runs, one to tie the game at the end of the, or near the end of the second quarter. And here to start the second half, he bolts after the kickoff.
And we'll see how Union reacts the first time this year they have been behind. As they shut out the California schools, so down 7 here in the third period. We'll see the character come out in the Redskins.
Well, a Rick Jones team normally doesn't beat themselves. And usually, once they get the momentum of their lead here, especially at home, although it's a new stadium, they're tough to deal with. Look at this move. Ramsey Stevens, the number 3 tailback, goes past midfield, but we've got a flag down back at the 30. After the 48-yard return. Union is walking backwards. And a hold, according to Dom Hamm.
Runner, 10-yard penalty.
JV pointed out. So the Redskins, JV, have shot themselves in the foot a few times. They had a touchdown to Janae called back. He hasn't touched the ball since. That was in the first quarter. They had a 48-yard kickoff return here, called back. Let's take a look at the top of your screen.
Because this is going to be a great run back and also a great field position, but there was a hold at the top of the screen, as you could see, as he went by, and that brings it back. Tough luck for the Redskins.
On 22-yard line, so they lost 30 yards in field position. Janae in motion, and he hasn't touched the ball since the first quarter. About 3 passes in the first quarter. Had a touchdown, called back. Not much room. And again, 62, one of the co-captains, John Frazier, 5'11", 220-pound senior, lurking in the way.
And you can see as momentum begins to change, you can see the Broken Arrow Tigers really just coming up and maybe playing just a little above themselves and continuously improving. And that's what good ball clubs do. They take advantage of that momentum swing.
Gooch in his first start last season in the season opener against BA, beat the Tigers 31-9. Again, Union has beaten BA 11 consecutive times. A series, as Dawson gets his first carry of the second half, a series that started in 1983 in the playoffs. Believe it or not, these two schools have been around, Broken Arrow especially, for a long time. There's a look at TU against Oklahoma State coming up Saturday. And we hope you join us in Oklahoma City on Channel 3 or Tulsa on Channel 9. What a big kickoff that is. And Saturday night at 6 o'clock. That's a 6 o'clock kickoff.
Dawson looks, fires, crossing pattern Janae. First down and in the BA territory at the Tiger 42-yard line.
Tyler Gooch is very effective, the quarterback for Union, on the rollout, throws on the run very well, and when you get the speed of Jerome Janae on a crossover pattern, pretty tough to stop.
Janae, to show you just how dangerous he is, in the previous two seasons, he's had 11 touchdowns of 30 yards or more on the particular scoring play, so he is a home run threat. He got 18 on the last one. Gooch might have bobbled the snap. Gets by one, but not by Tovar, the two-year linebacker. And the junior makes the big play behind the line of scrimmage.
That's a good aggressive play in there by Philip Tovar, Don, because Tyler Gooch did fumble the ball and momentarily couldn't get a good grip on it, but Tovar just stayed right after him and comes right in behind and makes a great tackle.
10 first downs on the night. Union after a loss of two there. Second down and 12. See on the screen for the BA Tiger 44. Tigers have the lead for the first time tonight. Two and a half gone, third quarter. Gooch rifling one over the middle. It's caught to the 20-yard line, and that's Blankenship with the grab. His second of the night. He caught a touchdown last week. In fact, caught Union's first touchdown of the season last week.
Great protection in here. The line's giving Tyler Gooch all the time in the world. Good route by Caleb Blankenship. And you notice right here, he's going to hang on to that football this time.
And what a job by Union to come right back. From their 22 to the Broken Arrow 17, where they have another first down. After the 27-yard pass play. Dawson again, he's looking for that 100-yard mark on the night. He's near the mark right now. He does have it indeed, 100 yards on the night for Trinity Dawson, his first 100-yard game.
Kind of had a mix-up in there, it looked like, and he was trying to kind of improvise going off the right guard there, but wasn't able to get the yardage that he was looking for.
You know, the Tigers normally, or rather the Redskins in years, have gone to the tight end, but last year not so much. They haven't gone to the tight end much here in the early going in 2000. Caught at the six and banged out of bounds. Adam Ray on the tackle and the catch made by Jonathan Chisholm, the senior, who caught two balls last week, and that's his second catch tonight. And that's a first and goal for Union.
And again, it's that rollout here by Tyler Gooch looking downfield, pursued rather heavily. A nice move on a crossover pattern in there by Chisholm to get open.
Fourth first down in this drive. And we've got a timeout. I think Union has called the timeout. So we'll take you to a break with 8 minutes, 22 seconds remaining in the third, and the Tigers holding on to a one touchdown lead. Welcome back to the new Tiger Field inside Broken Arrow Memorial Stadium. 10,000 standing room only here in Broken Arrow, and they came very early, 2 hours before kickoff. They were trying to get in the gates. Tyler Gooch has guided his team 72 yards down to the 6-yard line. Dawson looking for a hole and he can't find it. A lot of black shirts there. Led by 45, the linebacker Ben Lake, who had a couple of big plays last week against the Sapulpa. Caused two fumbles and had a tackle behind the line of scrimmage last week.
Jason Willite, the defensive tackle in there as well. They're just really playing tough defense, Don. Broken areas, tackle to tackle. They're just begrudging every yard that the Redskins get.
They have a lot of returning starters up front. Linebacker and on the defensive line. Union with a new offensive line this year, and Gooch trips and stumbles back to the 10, and that sets up third down and goal.
When you take a look at this carpet, Don, it's a fiber. It's not just a flat carpet, and I'm sure that he kind of drug his foot in there, as you can see, that tripped up on him. You have to get your feet up. It's like natural grass. You've got to put your feet up. You can't be dragging it. Well, a lot of times you can drag it on a hard surface carpet like they have at Union.
Wide receiver Janae at the top of your screen. Gooch instead goes the other way and finds his man. Touchdown, Union, on third and goal. And he hits J.J. Sheffield, his first catch of the game, and the senior hauls it in, and they're a point away from tying the game.
And we've talked about leadership of Tyler Gooch, and I think that's a good example of it right there. Had a bad break coming downfield, and he falls, gets the stumble, yet he comes back and picks up Sheffield on a slant pattern and gets him a touchdown.
So Jake Gibbons will try the extra point off the hold from Gooch with 6:56 remaining. No good. The kick is off to the left. Oh, my. Gibbons, who is pretty close to automatic, misses that one with 6:56 to go, third quarter. And the Tigers cling now to a one-point lead when we come back on Cox Communications. Well, last year, JV, it was an extra point that decided the game in the playoffs.
That one, of course, Don, occurred in overtime, and as we were talking in the break, it's very important, but I have to think that there's going to be more scoring by both teams in the remainder of this game, but nevertheless, Broken Arrow Tigers certainly making a stand for themselves here tonight in the new stadium.
Tigers get up to the 23-24-yard line. McCoy on the return as we take a look at the touchdown.
That's just a nice slant-in pattern and just a perfect pass in there by Tyler Gooch, and gives an opportunity to tie it. Of course, they missed the field goal, but
the extra point. I think he just pulled it to the left.
I don't see any deflection or anything. I think he just missed it.
It certainly was hooking. So it's 14-13, and the Tigers on first down get another hold from Clendenning this time. And Mike Ryan, the defensive end linebacker, makes what might have been another TD-saving tackle at the 32-yard line, a gain of 8.
Very impressive ground game and very impressive running in here. Not only by the quarterback, Clendenning, but Shane Jones, and the ground game that Coach Rick Jones has is certainly working tonight.
Clendenning has run the flex bone well, and he's certainly been aided by the work of Shane Jones. Jones gets the first down and picks up 9 more up near the past the 40 to the 41-yard line.
Clendenning is doing an excellent job at the quarterback, Don. On that last handoff, watch him go to the top of your screen. He went out of sight, but he was carrying out his fake to the right-hand side of the field. In a few minutes, he'll fake that up the center with Jones, and he'll keep it.
8th first down of the night, and Jones doesn't get the call. This time it's Clendenning, and the first-year starting quarterback for the Tigers moves it to the 45-yard line, and the junior has done a nice job in this game controlling this flexbone offense.
And I think you can really compliment the offense because every one of them carries out their assignments, and this is what you have to do to have the type of offense that you run out of the flexbone.
2nd and 6. Nowhere to go that time as Clendenning handed off late to Shane Jones. Jones got a yard, and that's about it. Jones has got to be right at the close to the 200-yard mark. Jeff Dunn tells me 195, and keep in mind only 2 other Tigers in the long Broken Arrow history of football that went goes clear back to at least 1912. And only 2 have ever rushed for 200 yards plus.
And one of the main points right now that Coach Rick Jones wants to do is to shorten the game, and you shorten
right
it by keeping the ball with your offensive team and keeping it on the ground, keeping the clock running. There
so
you can see Shane
numbers.
Jones, 1,195 yards. That is, that's 2 weeks' work for a lot of good backs.
Keith Jacobs was the last running back to rush for 200 yards in a game 2 years ago. In fact, he became Broken Arrow's first and only, obviously, if he was the first, 1,000-yard rusher. And that is an amazing number when you look at the great players that Broken Arrow has had and the attack that they have featured of running the football, tough defense year after year, and to only have one 1,000-yard rusher. Keith Jacobs was it. He's still on the squad, but he's been out the first couple of games. That's him in motion there. And Jones on third and five is stuck. Somebody came up and introduced themselves. 32 Mansfield and 44 Dupree. They've been rather silent, to be quite honest, up until this point since early in the game. Dupree is a big-time player.
Going over the left guard there, it was just both of the linebackers. They had their shoulders together. That's a hard-hitting tackle.
So near midfield, Broken Arrow will punt for the first time in this half. Third time in the game, and we got a flag down. 4:05 remaining in the third. Might be a first down. I think Union might have jumped in the encroachment zone. Bill Blankenship looks on. Says, yep, come on off. Let's go.
Timeout was called before the flag was thrown.
Well, now they're going to call off the penalty. JV, is there any thought that, although we got a long way to go, 4:05 left in the third, that this Union team might have overlooked this game for the Jinx Union game next Thursday at Skelly here on Cox?
Well, you don't like to think that would happen, and the coaching staff, I'm sure, has done everything they can do to prevent that. But, you know, in reality, yes, the kids think about that, but I don't think it would affect the who wins or loses this one.
Jack, down to you.
Just a couple of comments. They picked up the flag because too many men on the field for Union, but the play hadn't actually been run. Nobody snapped the football, so they take the flag away, and you are correct. They were fortunate because it would have been a first and 10 for Broken Arrow. Last play when they had third and five, they changed the play because the Union player who went off, player that replaced him, they felt like on the sideline, hey, maybe this guy isn't ready, prepared, you know, to come into the football game. So they ran the play right at him, but a good job by Union in making the stop.
Yeah, the linebackers certainly were there to greet Shane Jones. Look at this boot. Sanders. Well, it dies for him. You got to love the turf. It cost $432,000, and it paid off for him right there as it's downed just outside the five-yard line. Another great punt by Aaron Sanders.
Seems like every punt that we've seen tonight has had that backspin on it, and it hasn't gone downfield very far.
OU coming up on the pay-per-view against Arkansas State September 9th this Saturday. $24.95 is all it costs. You can call Cox Communications in the Tulsa market at 665-0200 and get set up. Bill Land and Gary Reason will give you the game. Hope you'll join him for that Saturday night at 6:30. Union, nowhere to go. 58, introducing himself again as the senior defensive tackle, Tom Arnold. And keep in mind, the Tigers have lost to Union 11 straight times.
This Union, Broken Arrow defense is really fired up, Don, and you can see Tom Arnold coming across there, and he's just not going to be denied whatsoever. Hanging on, getting him down.
There have been some great games in this series. As you look at the first down marker, Gooch has to throw off his back foot. Oh, Philip Tovar had an interception and 11 yards for pay dirt in front of him. Oh. Gooch hasn't thrown many incompletions.
That's just great pressure in there by the Broken Arrow defensive line, forcing him to throw off balance. And I think he was trying to get the ball out there to Jerome Genet, but wasn't able to complete it.
Broken Arrow fans are on their feet. They love what they see tonight. Look at Gooch's passing numbers, 11 of 13. And a touchdown pass called back in the first quarter. Caught five passes tonight, one for a touchdown. Gooch in trouble again. Nice dump. And out of bounds. And a first down, but we've got a flag down. As Stevens goes down. That was just past the first down marker. An eligible receiver again.
And that can happen so easily during the scramble. Again, that offensive line will get out and thinking it's going to be the run, so they're downfield trying to help them.
Ineligible receiver downfield.
And the pass comes at the last moment.
The 5-yard penalty. Replay the down.
Tell you what, the Redskins again make a costly mistake with 3:08 to go in the third. Let's see what the Tigers do here. On third and long. They've got them backed up where they want them at the 4-yard line, and Gooch now will load the gun. Janae, lone receiver to Gooch's right. He's going long. Now cuts out. The pass over the middle. What a attempted grab. But Tovar reached in, it appears, and knocked it away after Caleb Blankenship looked like he had it.
And what a great series that was defensively for Philip Tovar, because he made two great defensive plays. One against McCaleb that we just saw, and one against Jerome Janae in the play earlier.
So from the 4-yard line, Union will have to punt.
Great protection in there, giving him plenty of time to get to release the ball. A good crossover pattern, but just a great defensive play in there by Philip Tovar, number 11, to prevent the completion.
Here's the punt by Spavitaugh. Nice roll for him near midfield, and Broken Arrow will take it just inside Union territory with 2:53 to go here in the third period. Tigers leading by 1 point, 14-13, thanks to a missed extra point by Union.
Big possession coming up here for the Broken Arrow Tigers. This is one that they would like to, great field position, they'd like to get some points on the board.
And waste as much of the clock as they can. Well, we've got a game coming up for you Friday night. The Bulldogs of Edmond Memorial visiting the Huskies of Edmond North. Two new coaches taking off on that game Friday night. Almost intercepted. Gibbons had his hands on it, as did Broken Arrow's Jameson Hummel. It was up for grabs, falls incomplete, makes it second down and 10. You can see the Edmond Memorial Edmond North game on Channel 3 in the Oklahoma City metro area and Channel 9 here in the Tulsa area. Toby Dardy, the new head coach at Edmond Memorial. Bill Bays, the former UConn offensive coordinator, now at Edmond North. Rick Jones and Bill Blankenship know about coaching at Edmond. They both were there at one time, and here they are in the midst of this 17th meeting between Union and Broken Arrow.
Again, the workhorse, Shane Jones, picking up a few yards, Don. And more importantly, that clock is running, and they're managing the clock. Rick Jones, the coach of Broken Arrow, is, and trying to shorten the game as much as he possibly can. Just a nice straight handoff. And in there following his big lineman, Chris Ryder, picking up a few yards.
Third down and 6 on the Union 45. 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Tigers leading 14-13, and Clendenning unloads, man's deep. And Spavitaugh might have got a hand on it, intended there for Matt McCoy.
Pretty good coverage in there, but it looked like that maybe Matt McCoy could have gotten his hands on it and held on to it. That's a nice pass in there by Clendenning on the run. We'll get a closer look right here and see.
He didn't get a hand on it.
He didn't get a hand on it. He just missed it. It was that's tough, though, when it comes over a defender like that. It's not an easy catch.
So Sanders will try to pin them deep as he did last time. This is high, but not far. Oh, and it takes a Union bounce. Well, that's the break Union was looking for with a minute 50 to go here in the third quarter.
Union picks about 20 yards on the exchange punts.
After a 43-yard punt, this one only good for about 11. Well, TulsaSportsWeb.com, one of our sponsors, and it asks you which high school quarterback was the last to throw 5 touchdown passes in a playoff game. Was it Justin Fuente of Union, Josh Blankenship of Union, Mickey Nickel of Broken Arrow, who grew up in the Union District, or Mike Gundy of Mid-Des City? Mike now an assistant at Maryland. 1:50 to go, third quarter. Gooch, great play action. And the completion to Blankenship. And he's up near midfield and into BA territory. What a play by the Union quarterback to the Union senior receiver, Caleb Blankenship.
That's really stretching the ball out there and stretching the field out for you and allowing Caleb to get over the middle and come across on the slant pattern. And if you notice, once he catches the ball, now Tyler's looking for him. Once he catches the ball and the pressure comes, he does a little spin right here when Adam Ray comes at him, picks up an extra 3 yards just by spinning off.
22 yards on the play. They have been unable to run the ball much. Ramsey Stevens is their third tailback of the night. And he crosses the 40 and bulls his way down to the Tiger 38-yard line as we approach the one-minute mark of the third quarter. This one apparently going to the wire tonight.
Nice block in there. Breaking him loose by number 51, Robert Beams.
Beams is one of the youngsters on that offensive line, or one of the guys, I should say, that hasn't played much, but is a senior. Janae dancing, gets the first down at the 32-yard line. They love to get Janae one-on-one outside. He spent his summer, Jerome did, in Los Angeles with his father and working out a lot near the UCLA campus, and that's one of the schools I understand that is heavily recruiting Jerome Janae. Kansas State, OU, or others.
Look at the block in here that Caleb Blankenship throws. Didn't quite spring him because of the good flow across by Philip Tovar, and has he had a great game tonight? He's playing sideline to sideline for Broken Arrow.
We have a flag, but a player down, I should say. There's a look at the passing yardage. Nothing unusual for Union. They are a very balanced group, as they usually are. Let's go down to Jack.
We'll check out that injury for you in just a moment. Wanted to let you know that there are so many people in here. Rough estimates by some folks here is there might be not only the 10,005 people that it holds, but maybe an additional 4,000 people. And in fact, there were still people in line at the end of the first quarter trying to get in. Now, I bring that up mostly because next week when it's Jinx and Union at Skelly Stadium and there are maybe three times as many fans, possibly, if we get as many as we had last year at the state championship, then you better get there early.
Match of the 99 state championship game, which was held there before 40,000. Derek Leggett comes in for the injured defensive tackle. Is this Leggett? I think it is, that makes the play. No, it's Tom Arnold, 58. Leggett is 59, or Josh Rogers, 59. Leggett is 69, it is. He's into the game as a defensive tackle in place of Will Hyde, who limped off.
Tom Arnold's been around that football much of the night as well, out of his defensive line position.
His older brother Jerry playing at Southwest Missouri State. One of two BA Tigers up there playing for the school out of Springfield. On second and long, Gooch again with all kinds of time, and he finds Blankenship again in a first down Union as we'll end the third period. When we come back, the Redskins are knocking on the door again, but they trail after three periods. It is the eighth-ranked Tigers leading the second-ranked Redskins 14-13, and we're coming back to Broken Arrow just east of Tulsa in a moment on Cox. Welcome back along with producer Paul McFarland, Jack Buns on the sidelines, Jeff Dunn giving us the numbers here in the booth, along with J.B. Haney. I'm Don King, and it's a pleasure to have you with us for week number two of the 2000 prep season, and we welcome you around the state watching the curtain being raised on the new $8 million, 10,000-seat Broken Arrow Memorial Stadium. They have got their money's worth here tonight. We start the fourth quarter. Blankenship has been brilliant tonight catching the football. First down from the BA 16. Tigers leading by a point. And Gooch wants to run the ball, and they punish him. Mike Condry, number 89, makes the stop. He had a brother, Bo, that played here a few years ago, also a very good baseball player. Look at the arm of Tyler Gooch. He's got some burns on those arms.
Yeah, it looked like maybe he was going to try to make a pitch, but he turns up and does a good job of protecting the football and great pursuit in there, the broken arrow defense. Don, you couldn't write a script for a game any better than what we've seen here tonight, and especially heading into the fourth quarter, 14-13 broken arrow.
Very reminiscent of what we saw in the quarterfinals last year at Union that ended up Union winning in overtime, 34-33. Draw play, and it works to perfection, and Dawson's to the goal line, and it is a... They're going to mark it just outside the goal line. No touchdown, and the Union fans yelp about the call on the far side, all 3,500.
This is just a great fake by the quarterback in getting the ball as he hands it off in there to Trinity Dawson. You see him slide down the line, find that open hole, then he heads upfield. Good senior leadership from the quarterback. Knee hit the ground before he went into the end zone.
They didn't make it here, did they? Gooch was second effort. Still no signal yet. They're going to rule him down. Apparently his knee was down before he got the goal line. And the Union fans don't like it. The Tiger fans are on their feet. Bill Blankenship.
We'll get another look at it here. Let's see if he got in. Well, he's so small you can't see in behind there. Here he's sliding down. He may have gotten in, Don, unless they had blown it dead.
Gooch last year with 12 touchdowns in similar situations, and this time he does make it from a yard out, and the Redskins are back on top with 10-14 remaining in the game. Now, do you go for two? You've got to now, right?
Yes.
It's a five-point game. After they missed the extra point a moment ago in the third quarter. So a nice drive by the Tigers, and they were helped by the short punt of broken arrow, and they went 66 yards. Gooch loses the ball, and the Tigers are on the run again before finally being brought down is Frazier. And Frazier comes up limping a bit.
Tyler Gooch is having a little problem on the exchange from the center. It seems like that it's just not as smooth as the coaching staff would like.
We'll come back. Plenty of time left. This one's still up for grabs between two state-ranked teams in BA. Let's take a look here, JV, at the go-ahead touchdown.
Well, that's Tyler Gooch. He just steps off and goes over his left guard and a tackle and sneaks it in there. You know, he thought he'd been there the time before, but giving them the five-point lead. But Don, now the game has been shortened, not for broken arrow, but for the Union Redskins. Broken arrow now has to become much more aggressive on offense than they would have had they had the lead. So it's still just a wide open 10 minutes of high school football remaining.
Well, here's the kick. It's going to be rather short. Uh-oh, loose football, out of bounds it goes. How are they going to rule this one? And it'll be BA's ball just inside the 30-yard line. Jumping up and down for Union is Josh Dupree. He thought he came up with it, and I think he did, but he was out of bounds.
It just looked like on the camera angle I was looking at here on the screen that the ball had crossed the line before Josh Dupree got there. It looked like a good call by the official from our vantage point. So we can see it down the line, but it looks like the broken arrow kid was the last one to touch it, and he was out of bounds.
Let's go down to Jack.
Just wanted to real quickly update you. Jason Wilhite, sprained ankle, lineman for Broken Arrow. He should be all right. They're retaping his ankle, and they expect him to be back in. Meanwhile, Tom Arnold, one of their other linemen that's playing both ways, he kind of banged up his left shin or ankle as they were trying to hold there at the goal line. So they're going to have to get the offensive line blocking a lot. It's got him this close in the football game, but it could be a lot tougher down the stretch if those two guys can't get back in quickly.
Thank you, Jack. Good work. Up to the 36-yard line after the 6-yard run by Shane Jones. He's working on the school record here. 230 yards by Keith Jacobs a couple of years ago against Owosso. Jones tonight has touchdown runs of 68 and 80 yards to give the Tigers They're 14 points. They trail by five right now with 9:42 to go. That's a first down, though, for the Tigers.
207 yards Shane Jones has rushed tonight. Great work. And you can see how he just bounces off in there, gets some good blocking up front. And it takes a couple to get him down.
This time he can't keep his balance in the 44's meet. Jones for BA and Dupree for Union. Dupree's an interesting character. He's a guy that wears contacts. I don't know if he is this year, but last year was wearing contacts. One green contact and one red contact. Pretty scary.
Yeah, when you look across the line at someone like that, I'm sure that maybe breaks your concentration just a little.
Just a tad. Clendenning's done a nice job tonight, JB.
He's done an excellent job. He has run the flex bone to just about as good as you could expect him to do coming in here as a junior, or rather senior, starting for the first time.
67.
No, he is a junior.
67.
Yeah. Procedure against the Tigers. They have not
ball,
had many penalties tonight. That one pushes
team,
them back
yards.
To the 41-yard line. Only two penalties tonight. Both of the five-yard variety. Rick Jones has to be pleased about that. Last week, they had eight penalties for 60 yards. Bill Blankenship's team, though, has had some penalties. You saw 99 behind Bill Blankenship, maybe Cameron Goodwin. He's a starting lineman that hurt his knee and is out. I've heard that he's going to be out for quite some time, and that's a blow to that defensive line of Union because they are loaded on the D-line. Clendenning breaks loose. Midfield. First down to the 41-yard line of Union with 8.5 minutes to go. On a second and 13, and he scoots for a first down after a gain of 18 yards.
He has just more or less taken over the Broken Arrow offense and carrying them on his back. You can see him getting around, and now there's a nice cut right there. He's able to avoid a tackle. Look at him put both hands on that football and hold on to it.
The Tigers are trying to snap an 11-game losing streak to Union. Shane Jones bounces to the 30-yard line, and he's close to the first down marker.
Looks like Shane Jones has found a soft spot on the right-hand side. He's just going to keep working it.
No signal yet. They'll measure for the first down. That gives us a moment while they measure to pass along our condolences. We lost a coach recently, Holland Hall, Joe Lowry, a few weeks ago to cancer, JB. And I know Joe Lowry will be missed by the Holland Hall system. He was a longtime basketball coach and defensive coach for Holland Hall. They'll miss him.
Just not only an outstanding coach for Holland Hall, but he was an outstanding teacher and motivator as well. Certainly loved by all of the student body of not only Holland Hall, but when he was at Bishop Kelly as well. And certainly will be missed.
Broken Arrow with long tradition in football, but they are still looking for their first state championship in football. And there's a look at the first downs as BA has just collected another.
15-10.
Shane Jones is 3 yards away from establishing a new school record, and he's got it, and he's got more. Shane Jones for his third touchdown. Hello. Tigers are back in front with 8:10 to go. I think you're going to have to bring this one back. The 30-yard run is going to be negated because of a holding penalty.
We'll replay the down.
So both teams have had a touchdown tonight called back due to a penalty.
And both of those touchdowns were so crucial. The one that was called back by Union earlier, Don, would have given them a 14-0 lead. And this one would have given the lead back to Broken Arrow by Shane Jones. And he just really broke a tackle in there off of Aaron Rooney. You'll see Aaron Rooney, number 90, try to ramp him up, and he just burst through there. What great strength the young man has in his legs. And you see those arms and legs moving. He is going.
So they're back near the 40-yard line. He gets it again. This time he's bulldogged inside the 40 at the 37-yard line, and Darryl Mansfield makes sure he doesn't go any farther. Number 32, two-year starter, the Redskins.
And this is a defensive stand on the part of the Redskins that they almost have to stop them here. That clock going down and the way they control it, if they Broken Arrow is able to control it and score it on, then there will be very little time left for Union. Big defensive stand.
It's a yard away from the school record. Union 37-yard line, second and long. Clendenning hasn't thrown the ball a lot. Here he goes deep. He's got a man, but it's overthrown. Janae on the coverage, and Jason Ray was the intended receiver, and Janae's down. He needs some help. I think he's got a cramp. That's Keith Stanley from Eastern Oklahoma Orthopedic Center to take care of him.
And those are painful. Get some fluid down him. We see a lot of those in the early stages of high school football when the weather is hot.
This has been a series that has been very competitive between Union and Broken Arrow. I mentioned Broken Arrow has not won a state championship in football. They won a boys basketball 6A state championship just a few years ago. Steve Spavital, the former Sepulpa head coach, looks on. In fact, when Spavital was the head coach at Sepulpa, his offensive coordinator was Bill Blankenship.
Those two really share a lot of the same philosophy and been together for so long, and each as an assistant, that's a remarkable combination and relationship that those two coaches have.
B.A. Thank you. TU against OSU Saturday night. We hope you'll catch it at 6 o'clock. That is the kickoff time. It is statewide. Oklahoma City, Channel 3, Tulsa, Channel 9. 6 o'clock Saturday night on Cox Communications. Rick Jones took Edmond to the state championship in 89, but the Tigers have yet to win their first state championship in football. They have won many in softball, having won 5, finished runner-up to Union last year in girls softball. Broken Arrow, 5 state championships in softball and 7 runner-up.
Dr. Stanley has him back on the sideline, and I'm sure we're going to see Jerome Janae back in here very shortly.
Well, Broken Arrow's got a tough task ahead of them here. 3rd and 17. They need to get inside the Union 20 for a first down. There are Clendenning's numbers, 2 of 7. They come after him. He airs it out. Incomplete. Jake Gibbons on the coverage, and he just got his hands in it inside Hummel to knock it away, and it'll bring up 4th down. Now Aaron Sanders can kick the field goal, but that still puts B.A. down by 3.
A little pressure coming in there on the quarterback, and this just a great move in there by Jake Gibbons. He's got his eye on the ball and goes for the ball. The contact that occurs is just the natural thing that happens, but good defense by Gibbons.
So look at Hummel, the wide receiver. Now an interesting situation. Do you fake? Do you try to pin them deep like you have a couple of times tonight? Sanders, I think this one's too much air, and it's into the end zone. So Union will take over at the 20. Can they hang on with 7:15 remaining, leading by 5? Welcome back to our Thursday game of the week. Don King, J.B. Haney, and Jack Bunce. Well, everybody's on their feet, all 10,000. You can't blame them. 7:15 to go in the game, and the number 2 ranked Union Redskins with Tyler Gooch at QB trying to run out the clock, leading by 5, and they get a nice pass play to the tight end. And again, we told you earlier, they very rarely throw to the tight end anymore, but here they hook up with the sophomore, Brock Gruenberg, up at the 35-yard line.
Once again, stringing it out across the field over there, Tyler Gooch doing an excellent job. Did a good fake up the middle. He rolls out trying to pick up his receiver. Eludes a tackler there, throws it on the run, and just a great catch in there by Brock Gruenberg. Spinning, picking up an extra couple yards on the first down.
Broken Arrow really can ill afford to give Union many more first downs. And a nice run here by Trinity Dawson. We have not seen much of him here in the fourth quarter, but he has had some big runs for this Union team.
And when you look at the 1,000-yard rushers throughout the 90s, Union has had one seemingly every year. You go back to last year with Jason York, 1,400 yards. Before that, it was Chris Claiborne, who had a big game last week, 120 yards rushing for Washington or for Kansas State. Before that, Eric Bennard, who played at Texas A&M.
Always had that one good running back.
Always had a good running back, and Dawson apparently is going to be the guy at least tonight. And he's close to the first down marker, and I think he has it.
And this is where the Broken Arrow defense just has to make a stand. They can't let them get many more first downs. That clock is running. 18 attempts, 100 and some yards there. But Trinity Dawson, he is too a workhorse.
No touchdowns, even though he had one, I believe, last week. Had one last week. He rushed for 68 yards a week ago. Bill Blankenship's been working that towel over tonight. I have never known him to clutch to a towel like Jerry Tarkanian, but he's working it over tonight.
Well, those penalties is something that really gets a coach excited, yeah, over there and upset because of mistakes.
Well, they're near midfield with 5:47 to go. So they're breathing easier. The Redskins are, anyway, as Blankenship's in motion. They go the counter. They love to run this play. Dawson shows you why. He buries a defender to the first down marker. Ben Lake, the linebacker, making the tackle. But Dawson will move the chains again. And that's the 14th, or more than that, that's the 16th.
Great block in here by Justin Brown, 62. You see him pulling out and really opening up the hole there for Trinity Dawson.
19th first down for BA. Don't forget OU pay-per-view coming up 6:30 Saturday night. And you can call here in the Tulsa market at 665-0200. Arkansas State's not bad, folks. They took North Carolina State to double overtime last week. Gooch for Janae, overthrown. Well, they were trying to break the backs of the Tigers there with 5:07 to go. Casey Jones covering.
That's something that you can always expect out of a Bill Blankenship coach team, though, Don, is that once he gets an opportunity there, he will go for it regardless of the time, regardless of the situation.
Union next week, playing Jinx, Thursday night game here on Cox from Skelly Stadium. Broken Arrow opening their new stadium, and everybody has gotten their money's worth tonight. 5:07 to go in the game. Clock stop. Second and 10 for Union. Mike Cook chases Gooch out, and he runs out of bounds. And the Tigers like it. And a flag down as Frazier, one of the co-captains, bumped him harmlessly, but nevertheless, a foul against the Tigers.
And if you notice there, Coach Blankenship, he grabbed Tyler Gooch very quickly, prevent any kind of words. A good roll out here. Decides to tuck it and run.
Dead ball foul.
And then once he goes out of bounds, he gets bumped in there.
We got a dead ball foul on 62 hitting out of bounds.
You know, you have a hard time faulting a player when something like that happens, Don. They're so excited. They're so keyed up for the game. 25-yard penalties for Broken Arrow. 45 for Union with five flags, only three flags for Broken Arrow. But that was a pretty crucial one right there.
First, 20th first down of the night for the Skins at the BA 20-yard line. Dawson looking for room. It's about five, and then uses some strength to get more, and a flag goes down after the tackle. A lot of black shirts, JB. That's one thing you can always count on a Rick Jones team, is a lot of black shirts, and Justin Fiorentine is slow in getting up. He was at the bottom of that stack. His father was a very good player at Memorial in the 70s. Andy Fiorentine, one of the twins.
He got a penalty of 5 yards, aiding the runner. Player pushing his opponent against the white team.
We can see the foul here.
Yeah, right at the end of the play, you'll see the player come back in and just shove the whole pile forward. The penalty will occur right there on 74. But again, the excitement that these kids have. I'm surprised, Don, there hasn't been maybe a 17-game.
First down, Gooch. Buries his head and runs into Marcus Colbert, the sophomore defensive back. And the clock runs. It's plenty of time left, 4.5 to go. But Union is knocking on the door at the Broken Arrow 12-yard line. Keep in mind now, if BA can stop them, Union has a good field goal kicker in Jake Gibbons, and a field goal would give Union an 8-point lead, setting up a Tiger touchdown and 2-point conversion to send this into overtime. So we're far from over.
Look at Tyler Gooch just lower his head and goes right into Marcus Colbert, picks up an extra 3 yards.
Third and one. Gooch, he doesn't want to pitch it to anybody. He wants the ball himself.
And he wants to keep that clock running as well.
And he's down to about the 7-yard line. There have been some great games that we have talked about in this series. Broken Arrow's had some great teams the past few seasons, and they're trying to hang in this one.
That's a good cut by Tyler coming back in there and just lowering his shoulder, getting as many yards, but had a little late hit coming there. They missed, didn't they?
There's the first down comparison. Remember, it was much closer in the first half. And also remember, the Tigers had a 30-yard touchdown round called back in this fourth quarter, and Dawson buries his head, runs over a Tiger, and puts the Redskins in front by 11 with 3:28 to go. His first touchdown of the night. The Tigers now have their work cut out for them, down by 11. And the Redskins will again go for two. This to put them up by 13. Gooch just airs it out. And the pass fails here with 3:28 remaining. And an 8-yard touchdown run by Trinity Dawson. After the Redskins go 80 yards. .328 remaining. Can the Tigers score twice in the final 3.5 minutes? High but short kick. Three Tigers there. And a fair catch called for at the 16-yard line by number 66, Eric Gunning. Downstairs to Jack Bunch.
You know, that extra point, so critical that Union just missed. It's going to be hard for Broken Arrow to score twice, especially with the offense they run. But if they score a touchdown, get two, they're down by three, a field goal, and we'll go to overtime just like we did last year. I would have gone for one.
Good point, Jack. And, you know, you talk about the offense they run, it's going to be hard to score, but yet Shane Jones, he runs that 40 in about 4.5, 4.4, 4.6, so he can go from one end of the football field in a few seconds.
Union has been to the state championship game three times in the 90s, losing in 94 to Midwest City, a team that went undefeated with Vernon Maxwell, Raymond Cato, Josh Black at receiver. They lost that game 21-13. They've lost the jinx in the finals the last 2 years. In two epic battles, they're looking to get to the state championship for the third straight year. Of course, we're still very early in the season to be talking about state championships, as you see Clendenning's numbers. But certainly a state championship atmosphere next Thursday night at Skelly Stadium when the Trojans and the Redskins meet yet again. Clendenning near the 20-yard line.
Union defense now just wants to keep the ball in front of them. Even if they pass, just keep in front. Don't let anything go deep and don't turn anyone loose for the long gainer, but they can put up with the 5, 6, 7 yard gains.
Rick Jones, every time we get with him before a Broken Arrow Union game, we talk about some of the games in this series. And he always harks back to a game when he was the Union coach and beat Broken Arrow 5-3 back in 91. One of the most bizarre games you'll ever see in this series. Here's a catch up at the 35-yard line to the 40, and he almost broke it. Nice grab by Jamison Hummel. And that's a first down for the Tigers.
And of course, that stops the clock as they move the chains, but a great catch in there by Hummel. Not only does he do a good job catching it up in the air, but he breaks that first tackle and game-saving tackle there, or touchdown-saving tackle maybe coming in there by Joshua Green.
2 minutes to go. Clendenning airs it for McCoy and completes. Babatol on the coverage. 2 minutes to go. Actually, a minute 59. In that game of 91, both teams went up and down the field, but the defenses bent but did not break in that game. And with a minute and 6 seconds to go, Broken Arrow clung to a 3-0 lead. They had the ball inside the 10-yard line with their backs against the wall. They had to punt from their end line. They decided to take a safety in that game to make it 3-2. Then the free kick, and Union, with a minute to go, went down and kicked a field goal from Jason Jadimski with 2 seconds left. And Rick Jones and the Union Redskins escaped Broken Arrow's Kirkland Field with a 5-3 win in 91. There's the estimated attendance tonight in the first game ever here at Memorial Stadium in Broken Arrow and Tiger Field. And the field turf certainly held up nicely. Over $500,000 for the field turf. Same as what the University of Tulsa will unveil Saturday night against Oklahoma State. Here's the Utah pass. And Shane Jones, who's had a magnificent game, will not quit. However, that one's not going to go for much. Shane make it fourth down and long.
Breaking two tackles, Don, behind the line of scrimmage, and with the clock running down, he is still just giving it his all. Just a great competitor. You have to admire him. Coach Blankenship still not resting easy.
Nope. You look back at these Broken Arrow teams. In 95, they went 9-3. And the only three losses were the Union by 5, the Jinx by 10, and then by the Jinx in the playoffs. 97, they went 8-3. That might have been their better team. In 83, they won their first 8 games, then lost to Jinx 20-7 when Rocky Kalmus ran for 240 yards and 3 touchdowns. They then lost the Union when Josh Blankenship threw for 3 touchdowns against them. Then they advanced to the state playoffs and lost to a Sand Springs team 14-7 when the Sandites made it to the state semifinals. So Broken Arrow has certainly had some very good teams, and this one is not to be discounted of having another great season for Rick Jones, even though it appears they'll fall here to the number 2 ranked Redskins. With the incomplete pass, the Union team will take over and probably run the clock with a minute 7 to go. Gooch still in there. Flag is down and Gooch is down at the 30-yard line. I wouldn't think he'll even attempt a pitch or a handoff or anything.
No, I don't think you're going to see him pitching that football. And looks like he's come up there with a leg cramp.
Holding against Union, a minute to go in this game.
Got a hold on the offense. 10-yard penalty, replay the down.
Again, Union next Thursday night at Skelly Stadium. 7:30 kickoff. We'll start our pregame coverage at 7.
You can see in there on the line the hole as it comes up, but great effort in there by Tyler Gooch as he plants that right foot and goes upfield.
Union has won a state championship with their credit in 1963. Back, some say, it was the first legitimate state championship by a Tulsa County school. You ever thought about this? I mean, Jinx has a mayor. Broken Arrow has a mayor. Union, one of the largest school districts, one of the largest communities, so to speak. But it's not really a community, is it, JV?
It really isn't. Because
South Tulsa, but
the old Union High School, the old Union District, back when it was Class C,
yeah,
and then Class B, and it's worked its way on up, and there was never a town. There was never a town.
Certainly an outstanding school district. There's a look at Trinity Dawson, and his touchdown pretty much put the capper on this one this evening as the Tigers unveil a new stadium, and they'll certainly have many wins here at this $8 million facility. But everybody got their money's worth tonight, and what an effort by Shane Jones tonight. 2 long touchdowns, and there are the 19s, Bjornteen and Gooch. And again, these kids grow up in the same neighborhoods, and so they have grown to know each other throughout the years. Bill Blankenship looking for Rick Jones, and a couple of Edmond coaches will probably settle in tomorrow night and watch Edmond Memorial take on Edmond North here on Cox with Mick Cornett, Steve Marshall, Curtis Fitzpatrick, and the Wranglers coach Bob Curtis. We hope you'll join us for that action on Cox tomorrow night. Final score here, Union 25, Broken Arrow 14, much closer than the game would indicate with 8 minutes left. Broken Arrow scored what appeared to be the go-ahead touchdown on Shane Jones' 30-yard run, but it was called back, and then the Redskins got the ball back and went 80 yards to put this one away. We'll come back and wrap it up in a moment from Broken Arrow. Union runs their record to 2-0. BA falls to 1-1. Let's go downstairs to Jack Barnes.
Union coach Bill Blankenship visiting with some of the newspaper writers. We'll get in on their interview at the moment. 25-14, the final score as Union really comes on strong in the fourth quarter. Keep in mind they were down 14-13 after missing the extra point. Coach, what a strong performance fourth quarter, and fatigue not a factor for you guys.
Well, I tell you, our guys were getting tired. I know Jerome going both ways there got some cramps, and I was really proud of the way we fought through some real adversity there. And I tell you, Broken Arrow had them going. Their offense was clicking, and we had to go down and score. There was no question about it, and our guys answered the bell.
Shane Jones just had a phenomenal night. Had a lot more speed than I thought he did.
No, Shane's a great player. He's not just a good player. He was out a week ago with a concussion, and you can tell the difference when he's in the game. I mean, they certainly are able to ride that fullback in there and give him the ball.
Had to be very proud of the heart and soul of Tyler Gooch, yep. Trinity Dawson as well.
Oh, the senior stepped up and really got that look in their eye, and I really think this is something we can build on and call back in the future when we need to have it.
Might have to call it back pretty soon. Next week, a huge game.
It'll be a huge game. I hope we have a great crowd, but more importantly, it'll just be the last game that doesn't count, and then we get into the regular season that ones that count.
Well, congratulations for a great ball game tonight and the victory.
Thanks, Jack.
Thank you very much. Bill Blankenship, the coach of Union, as they come out on top by 11 points.
All right, and they knock off the Tigers for the 12th consecutive time and now lead the series 14-3. People at Tulsa Sports Web said you've been jamming their signal so much that you can still get in and vote tonight. They haven't been able to get all the votes in. Which high school quarterback the last to throw 5 touchdown passes in a playoff game? Justin Fuente, Josh Blankenship, Mickey Nickel, or Mike Gunday? www.tulsasportsweb.com, and there is your answer. Josh Blankenship in 1998 threw 5 touchdown passes against the Stillwater Pioneers. We appreciate you voting online, and you can certainly do it again next week when Jinx meets Union. JB, your thoughts on the game tonight?
Well, Don, I was very much impressed with both teams' defense, even though they broke down some, but I thought the defenses were steady on both sides of the ball, and you have to admire Doug Clendenning along with Shane Jones because the heart of the offense is Broken Arrow, and they're going to continue to do what I think they did tonight. I think they will continue to do during the season. And on the other side, Tyler Gooch certainly showing the leadership of the quarterback and great receiving in there by Caleb Blankenship and Jerome Janae. Great to running in there by Trinity Dawson. So Union equally should be the number 2 team in the state, and we look for next week as the great one.
Oh, it should be good. Union against Jinx next week, number 1 against number 2, should the Trojans hold off Friday night and defeat a very good Fort Smith Northside team. And then Saturday night, we hope you join us for OU football as the Sooners take on a pretty good Arkansas State team. Josh Heupel, what a job by Tulsa Washington's Ronaldo Works last Saturday night in their win, and they'll try to go 2-0. And Cox Communications has it for you here in the Tulsa market, 665-0200. Also Saturday night at 6 o'clock. Now, the OU game at 6:30, the TU game at 6, as the Cowboys open their season against the University of Tulsa. And Al Jerkins, Brian Thompson, and myself will give you that game. Channel 3 in the Oklahoma City market, Channel 9 in Tulsa. Next week, Broken Arrow at home against Fort Smith Southside, and then we'll see the Tigers again in 2 weeks when they are at Jinx. Also, coming up on Friday night, Mick Cornett and the crew in Oklahoma City. Edmond Memorial against Edmond North. Both teams looking for their first win of the season. We'll kick it off with the pregame show at 6:30 and the kickoff at 7 o'clock tomorrow night, Friday night, September 8th, Oklahoma City, Channel 3, and Tulsa, Channel 9. So for our producer, Paul McFarland, and the rest of our crew, including Jack Buns and J.B. Haney, Don King inviting you to join us next week when Union meets Jinx from Skelly Stadium. We'll see you there on Cox Communications.